Nebraska sold out, as it has been for every game here since 1962. Today, two teams off to 2-0 starts go head-to-head for the third time in a year. Martinez throws, caught, first down and more. And it is a touchdown for Nebraska. Martinez after the fake. No chance they will catch him. 80 yards and a touchdown for Nebraska in the blink of an eye. Handed it off to Hello, and he's off to the races. Another long touchdown run for Nebraska.
Locker battles it, keeps it, has a crease. Hammers down into the end zone.
Well, the Husky defense set the tone for the game from the very first possession.
And they reverse the verdict of a 35-point home field embarrassment.
Two dramatically different games last season between the Huskers and the Huskies. Nebraska dominated the regular season game in Seattle. Washington came back to win the Holiday Bowl. So today, the rubber game, if you will, of this three-game series. Very unusual. The two college football teams play each other three times within the span of 1 year. And there were many differences, obviously, Matt, between those two games last season. The big difference in the second game, the Washington defense, much more physical, did a terrific job on the Nebraska quarterback, Taylor Martinez.
Yeah, and that really is the big difference. And that's going to be the big difference again today. Taylor Martinez, when he is on, when he is running the football, ooh, he is dangerous. Now, he can hurt you a lot of ways, but you give him a crack, there's nobody on the field who can catch him. Now, he can do that. He can do it consistently. In the Holiday Bowl, Washington got after him and beat him up. And then what they're going to try to do today is load that box and try to force him to throw. He has not been a high percentage thrower. He struggled a little bit with the passing game. And so that's exactly what Washington wants to do, get him into the throwing situation.
He's had already four runs of 40 yards or more for Nebraska as the Cornhuskers are getting ready to take the field before the 314th consecutive sellout here. That's the all-time college football record. Nebraska's 2-0, home wins over Chattanooga and a squeaker over Fresno State here last week. Bo Pelini, their coach, says, "I like the potential of our team, but right now I don't like our team all that much. We can be better." They expect to be better today. So the number 11 team in the country has taken the field. They'll take on a Washington team off to a 2-0 start. The Huskies try to get to 3-0 for the first time since 2001. Last year, they had one of the best quarterbacks in the country in Jake Locker. So a question at the start of this year was, how would the quarterback play be? And so far, after wins against Eastern Washington and Hawaii, Keith Price has been excellent.
Jake Locker was the number one pick, and Keith Price, I'm telling you right now, runs this offense better than Jake Locker. Now, is he accomplished yet? No, but he sees the whole field. He distributes the ball to everybody. And you're open, he finds you. He has a little bit of run in him, but he's a pure passer. This kid is a pretty thrower. He has a full understanding, and he will be the key for this Washington Huskies team today.
They call him Teeth Price because he's always smiling. His play has given Husky fans reason to smile. Washington and Nebraska, the rubber match right after this. John McDonough with Matt Millen will be joined by Heather Cox in just a moment. Nebraska hosting Washington. The Cornhuskers won the toss and elected to receive. They want Amir Abdullah to get his hands on the ball right away. The freshman out of Homewood, Alabama, last week in the win over Fresno State set the school record with 211 kickoff return yards, including a 100-yard return for a touchdown, second longest in school history. Eric Folt kicks off, and we're underway. Abdullah right up the near hash marks, bounces off a hit, and goes out of bounds at the 48-yard line.
They wanted him to get the ball. He got it and delivered. They want the ball in the hands of Taylor Martinez as well. Here's Heather Cox.
Yeah, Sean, Taylor Martinez returns for a second season, but ask anybody in this program and they will tell you he is an entirely different Taylor Martinez. Last year he was abundantly criticized for not being a leader, not being vocal, being soft, being reserved. So Bo Pelini challenged him in the offseason and it worked. Bellini says Martinez is light years ahead of where he was last year at this time. He's more engaged, and that maturity, Sean, will be critical in today's grudge match.
He's the third leading rusher in the nation right now. Comes out throwing and going deep and has a man open. Caught! First down inside the five, Kenny Bell, the freshman, on the receiving end of a 50-yard bomb after a 40-yard kickoff return.
First of all, the anatomy of a big play, you have to be protected. And he certainly is that. And then he just gets behind the defender. You can see right there, it's Quentin Richardson, 28. He bites on the play action. Bell gets on top of him. Actually had to wait for the ball.
Their ninth play of 40 or more yards, leading the country. Martinez dumps it off. Touchdown on just two plays. Tyler Legate, the fullback.
Nebraska sends a message early. If you want to try to stop the run, have some pass. Two throws, big score.
First touchdown of the season for Tyler Legate, one of those terrific former walk-ons, now on scholarship as a senior. Extra point up and good by Brett Maher. Two plays in 34 seconds. It's been a big play offense in the first two plus games of the year for Nebraska. Back in Lincoln, Nebraska. 34 seconds into the game, Taylor Martinez and the Cornhuskers have the lead. Second touchdown pass of the season. The sophomore from Corona, California, in Southern California. Big play, the 50-yard pass to Kenny Bell. Good kick by Maher. And Jesse Callier thought about coming out and then took a knee. So Washington on offense for the first time today. We look at their impact players on offense, brought to you by Chick-fil-A. Chris Polk, one of the best running backs in the country. Only Corey Dillon ran for more yards in a season than the numbers Polk put up last year. Austin Seferian Jenkins, a freshman tight end, has already been a big playmaker for the University of Washington. Their best receiver is Jermaine Kearse. Last season, 63 catches, only four of them in the two games against Nebraska. He didn't do much. They're looking for more from him against the Huskers. They find Kearse right away. And he gets 5 to the 25. Run down by Ciante Evans, sophomore cornerback for the Cornhuskers. They have plenty of impact players on defense. Up front, it's Jared Crick, preseason defensive player of the year in the Big Ten and preseason first-team All-American. Levante David was second-team All-American last year when he set the school record for tackles in the season with 152. Senior out of Miami, second and 5 for Keith Price. Sophomore quarterback out of the shotgun. Here's Polk with a big hole and a first down to the 32, a gain of 7. Tackled by Damian Stafford, the safety.
You know, Sean, if this offense is going to work today, Chris Polk has to be a big part of it. Now, he had arthroscopic surgery just a month ago. He's still not quite where he's at on his knee. And when he's on, though, this guy's a stud.
He has managed to run for more than 100 in their first two games, despite the fact he's not yet at full speed. He gets the call again and battles for two more. It'll be second and 8. Will Compton, the middle linebacker, made the tackle.
Yeah, Will Compton made the tackle, but Jared Crick made the play. This Nebraska defense will do as well as Crick does. Crick and Baker Steinkuhler inside are powerful guys. Crick's unique. He's got a chance. He'll be playing a lot on Sundays. He's the key to this defensive front.
Played alongside Ndamukong Suh here at Nebraska. On second and seven, Price a bullet and a first down. There's the stud freshman tight end, true freshman, Austin Safarian Jenkins, 6'6", 258 pounds. He caught it for 15 yards.
And if you notice, they lined him up outside wide. So what they tried to do, what Steve Sarkisian, the head coach, tries to do, he tries to get mismatches all the time. And so Safarian Jenkins gives him that opportunity. He's a big man. They'll split him outside. He can run.
Jesse Callier in at running back now. Price spreading it around again. Nice move after the catch by the true freshman, Kason Williams. Very highly recruited player. And Washington won that recruiting battle. 12 yards on the throw and catch. And mostly on the run after the catch by the true freshman from Sammamish, Washington.
Sean, for anybody who does not know this Washington team, I'll tell you, Keith Price is a heck of a football player. He knows and runs this offense extremely well, can make all the throws.
Whistles and a timeout called by the Nebraska defense on its heels.
Nebraska, their first.
Sean, this is a great opportunity to talk about Keith Price right here, because first, take a look right there. That is him. That's the epitome of Price. They call him Teeth Price. He's always got a smile on his face. He lights up a room. Any conversation you have, you come back from him, and it's just an uplifting experience. He's just one of those guys. But when you watch the tape of him, that makes you even happier, because that kid can see the whole field. If you're open, he will find you. He will throw it to anybody on the field. He's distributed to 12 different people. There's his grandmother right there.
Gail Manuel. Keith lived in Compton, California, in a very tough neighborhood. When he was going to high school, he decided to go live with his grandmother in Long Beach. He's starting to fall in with the wrong crowd. Some of his buddies were going into gangs. So he said his mother was a great influence, and his grandmother. Mother approved of the decision to send him down to Long Beach and away from some of the rough things he grew up around. He's throwing deep, and he has a receiver wide open. It's a touchdown. Jermaine Kearse. They wanted more against Nebraska from their senior wide receiver, and they've gotten it already.
He also got a flag, probably for celebrating. Not smart. Sean, this whole thing, Price, he executes it, but Steve Sarkisian had this defense and has this defense right now off balance. He is motioning and he's messing with coverage.
After the play, unsportsmanlike conduct infringing on the defense. That 15-yard penalty reinforced on the kickoff.
Abdullah will like to hear that.
Steve Sarkisian, the head coach, does call the plays. Former offensive coordinator at USC. He was an assistant there for 7 years over two stints before he came to Seattle.
That foul is on the offense.
Dave Whitvoet, the referee, correcting the call. And now Steve Sarkisian wants to know why. It is
what?
A Big Ten officiating crew, which is the conference in which Nebraska is playing for the first year. Haven't played a conference game yet. Eric Folt adds the extra point. So a terrific start for the two offenses. Keith Price with his 8th touchdown pass of the year.
ESPN's College Football on ABC. Brought to you by Buffalo Wild Wings. Wings, beer, sports. Buick. See real stories of human achievement on the Buick Human Highlight Reel at NCAA.com/Buick. And Ally Bank. No nonsense, just people sense.
Look inside the Osborne Athletics Complex here in Lincoln. Exhibits including Nebraska's 5 national championship trophies, tributes to their 3 Heisman Trophy winners. Washington answers the quick strike by Nebraska with a 6-play, 80-yard drive of its own. They should get excellent field position. unsportsmanlike conduct penalty assessed against Washington on the kickoff. So Eric Foulkes kicking off from his own 15-yard line. Line drive boot and a good one. Amir Abdullah started at the 13. He brought the opening kick off 40 yards. This one out to the 36-yard line for return of 23. Let's go back and take a look at the Washington score.
Steve Sarkisian uses motion very, very well, and he uses them as probes because you want to see what your defense is doing. Once he goes across in motion, now you're going to watch the safeties kick down. Now that declares, you know, it's man-to-man, and you're on the outside. Watch the move on the top. He bites hard on the out, and Price puts it right where it has to be, and that's six quick.
Taylor Martinez with Rex Burkhead, the running back. Taylor comes out throwing again and threw it behind Kenny Bell, who was flying up the field, and Martinez thought he was going to stop.
Well, for this Washington Husky defense, they know that even though they're coming out throwing, they have to get hits on the quarterback when he runs, and they have to be physical up front. That will be their recipe for success if they're going to have it today.
They hand it off to Rex Burkhead. He got three, tackled by John Timu. Here's a look at our Chick-fil-A impact players on offense for Nebraska, including Burkhead, who rushed for just under 1,000 yards last year. Already seen the impact Amir Abdullah can have, particularly in the kick return game. And Kyler Reed, 8 touchdown receptions, the single season tight end record last year. Like Safarian Jenkins of Washington, Kyler Reed can get deep down the field. Third down and 7. Washington, the worst third down defense in the country so far this year, but they break that play up. Court Dennison, the linebacker, dropping into coverage. Quentin Richardson in the neighborhood as well. It was intended for Tim Marlowe.
This is just well done by Court Dennison, the middle linebacker, and he's reading the third receiver, and that's all he's doing. And it was a cover two, so he goes to numbers right away. Numbers in that instance was inside, and he took it away.
Brett Maher on the punt to Devin Aguilar. Maher taking over for Alex Henry, now at the Philadelphia Eagles, who did the place kicking and punting the last couple of years. Low tumbling punt, and Aguilar brought it back to the 30. 39-yard punt, an 8-yard return. Tonight on ABC, road test weekend continues as Landry Jones leads the top-ranked Sooners into Tallahassee to take on E.J. Manuel and the fifth-ranked Seminoles in the game of the weekend. Well, a weekend with a lot of big games. This is the biggest tonight. Number 1 and number 5, Saturday Night Football, presented by Southwest Airlines, 8 o'clock Eastern, 5 Pacific on ABC. Tally of the motion, man, looked like the ball hit him. And Price had the fall on it for a loss. Back to the 26. They lost 4. Timing of the snap apparently just a little bit off from the set Drew Schaefer.
Now you might be right, Sean. At least, at the very least, it shielded the view of the ball. Price wasn't able to hold on to it.
Saw Price patting Schaefer. Perhaps it was Price's fault. With the timing as he called the signals. Now he goes under center on second and 14 with Polk, the running back. Price under pressure, dumped it off to Polk. He got chopped down by Damian Stafford. He'll mark it near the 33-yard line for a gain of 7. The Nebraska defense, for the third consecutive day, playing without one of the best cornerbacks in the country. Missed all 3 games now. Alfonso Dennerty is dressed today, but hasn't played yet this season. With a pulled quad muscle, very serious. Described as almost a torn quad yesterday by Carl Pellini, the defensive coordinator. Third and 6. Price. Incomplete and almost intercepted on the ricochet. Andrew Breen, who's the stand-in for Dennard, broke up the pass. First incompletion thrown by Price today, and Washington will punt.
Nice job by Green on the backside. It's man-to-man the whole way, and he just gets perfect position from the start of the throw and carries through with his knockdown.
Kyle Rasp, former walk-on, now on scholarship, is the punter. Line drive punt for Amir Abdullah. And good coverage by Washington as they got him on the ground at the 31. Jamal Kearse and Brendan Lopez covering that punt for the Huskies. Back in Lincoln, Nebraska, first quarter, Washington and the Cornhuskers tied at 7. Bo Pelini, in his fourth year as Nebraska head coach, has done a terrific job. He inherited a program from Bill Callahan that was down from where it usually is, and he has quickly brought it back up. At least 9 wins in each of his first 3 years. Rex Burkhead weaves his way out to the 40. They might even give him the 41 and very close to a first down. Justin Glenn and Desmond Trufant made the tackle. Glenn's in for Nate Felder, their usual starting free safety, who's not playing today. Suffered a hamstring injury last week against Hawaii. Nebraska goes quickly. Second and short. Burkhead again for the first down out to the 47. Princeton Fui Maono made the tackle. That was the story of those 2 games last year, Matt. Nebraska pounded Washington on the ground in the regular season. They had 3 100-yard rushers in that game, and Washington totally stuffed the run in the bowl game. Martinez is loose. Trufant chasing him and runs him out of bounds at the 25-yard line. 28-yard run.
Now just take a good look at this as a read option. The option is with the quarterback. See how his eyes are up? He bites, you go. He reads it perfectly. He has a blocker in front of him in Kyler Reed, and then he's off to the races. Well done by Trufant to take the right angle to get him out of bounds.
8.5 to go, first quarter. Martinez wants to throw again and throws it away in the general direction of Kyler Reed. Well defended there by Washington, and they've had plenty of practice defending the pass. Their first 2 games were against Eastern Washington and Hawaii, 2 spread offensive teams that throw the ball all over the place. They threw 114 passes at the Huskies, and Washington didn't defend it very well, giving up 403 pass yards per game. A totally different offense they're facing today. Martinez's pass batted down by John Timu, true freshman linebacker who came on a blitz and was effective.
Yeah, he was effective, and this Washington defense is going to have a lot of young freshmen be effective. They play a lot of young people, Sean. Sophomores, freshmen, and they put a lot of pressure on them. Nick Holt, their defensive coordinator, he knew he was going to have to put pressure on the young ones, so he had him go on extra duty learning this stuff.
Pistol look from Nebraska. Martinez again can't find anybody to throw it to, and he's tripped up for a loss on the play back at the 28. Court Dennison, the leader of that defense, middle linebacker who didn't play in that regular season annihilation last year, made the stop.
That's a good job by Court Dennison. He's sitting in his zone. First of all, there's coverage, so it takes away the throw. But Dennison running inside out. Again, good angle. He just nicked him and was able to stop him.
Field goal try now for Maher. 44-yard attempt. He's perfect as a college kicker coming in, and he's still perfect. Now 5 for 5 is the junior from Kearney, Nebraska. Had the big shoes of Alex Henry to fill, and he's filled them very well so far this year. Let's send you back to the studio now, get an update from Robert Flores.
All right, Sean, Taco Bell studio update. Last season, UCLA beat Texas 34-12 in Austin. Playing at the Rose Bowl, it's Case McCoy, one of the 2 new quarterbacks, 45 yards to DJ Grant. But the Longhorns have just turned the ball over deep in their territory. They still lead 7-0 first quarter.
Manny Diaz came with the blitz, but protect the football and get the field goal.
You know, that McCoy family down there, they have a sense of how to play quarterback. This kid looks like his brother. It's amazing. He sees the whole field. And this kid right here, Martinez, he knows how to play that position as well.
Heather Cox reported before the game, much more mature this year, interacts much more easily with his teammates. Last year, many in this part of the country thought that perhaps his dad was too much of a constant presence and influence. His dad, Casey Martinez, from most of the people we've talked to around the program, has backed off a little bit. Mauro Bondi kicks off this time. Fielded by Jesse Callier. And good field position for Washington as Callier crossed the 35. Tackled by Corey Cooper.
Sean, when you play so many young players, it's really imperative that you start fast to give the young guys some confidence, particularly in a setting like this.
It's a much better start in this regular season game for Washington than what we saw in Seattle last year when Nebraska led 14-0 after the Cornhuskers had run five plays. Polk got five for Steve Sarkisian on first down. Sarkisian now 14-13 as Washington has won six in a row. They won their last four last year and the first two this season. That's the fourth longest active winning streak in the country. Actually third longest now that Auburn went down to defeat today at Clemson. Polk in trouble. Out of trouble. Across midfield with a first down to the 48-yard line where he took a belt from Ciante Evans and Josh Mitchell.
He's not quite there yet, but he still possesses excellent balance. He's a hard man to tackle. He has, well, you see right there, good feet and then good balance. Runs through tackles. He's the cornerstone of this running game.
Worked in the offseason to improve his speed, become a bit more elusive. He said, I want to turn 20-yard runs into much longer runs. Play action pass by Price. Flushed from the pocket. He can run. And he slides down 2 yards short of a first down at the 40 with Jared Crick in close pursuit.
You know, Sean, we talked about Keith Price and his ability to see the field and make all the throws, but he's playing on a sore wheel right now. He got banged up in his knee. You can see his right knee wearing a brace. He's less than 100%.
He was limping noticeably during the game last week against Hawaii. It didn't seem to bother him. He threw for 315 yards and four touchdowns in that win. Not very big, generously listed at 6'1", probably closer to 6 feet. Polk has the first down and more. And you look for reasons, Matt, as he got the first down to the 30, why two games were so different last year. The first game, Polk had only 55 yards rushing against Nebraska. In the bowl game, he went for 177.
And that's what they'll need today. They have to have balance. And Sean, that 177, credit Polk, but also credit that offensive line. Again, that goes back to their ability to be physical, and that's what they were in the second game, and it looks like that's what they're trying to establish and are establishing right now in this drive.
Washington on the move again, trailing 10-7. Another play-action pass, and the ball is underthrown and intercepted by Levante David. It appears he's battling Safarian Jenkins. Yes, it is. An interception by David.
Now, this is a talented freshman tight end, but he has not played against the speed of anybody like Levante David. Here's Levante David, number four. Levante David has inside position, and now he loses it. Loses the position. Now watch him skirt to the ball. Now the ball was a little underthrown, but that guy can flat out fly. And it's that ability to be able to run like that that will really carry him to the next level.
Amir Abdullah, a running back now. He gets his first carry of the day from scrimmage. Everett Thompson made the tackle in the middle of that Washington defensive front. And even after he throws an interception, he's still Keith Price, just managing to smile and shrug it off. It's the second interception he's thrown against eight touchdown passes this year. The first interception of his senior season for Levante David. The option, Martinez with plenty of running room. Nebraska changed offensive coordinators this season. Tim Beck now the coordinator and brought back some of the old-fashioned Nebraska option game and put it to good use.
That's a heck of a job of an open field tackle right there. That's as good as it gets by Sean Parker, just a freshman. They like him a lot, and it's easy to see why. Good angle, came right down and was decisive.
First and 10, Huskers at their own 25. Rex Burkhead, stutter step for a yard. It'll be second and 9. There's Tim Beck. He was on the staff last year, elevated to offensive coordinator. Sean Watson, the offensive coordinator last year, is now an assistant in Louisville.
So, Sean, the difference in this offense, you can see it. It's subtle, but Martinez has the option to be able to have options, where a year ago they did not have that.
I think they're better able to get to the perimeter by using the option. And that's what Martinez did there, carried out to the 32. 7-yard gain on first down. Court Dennison, another tackle.
And that Court Dennison, first of all, that's a good name for a middle linebacker. It just sounds right. Court. Not quite Dick Butkus, but it is. Court Dennison sounds good. And he plays well. He has a very good understanding of his interior people. Finds the ball very well.
Illegal procedure. 5 men in the backfield. 5 yards from the previous spot.
Wow.
Repeat, second down. Please reset the clock to 3:48.
That took a while to sort out. Flag was way over, just barely on the field on the Nebraska sideline. So instead of a gain of 7, it's a 5-yard walk-off. Second down and 14. Martinez might be changing the play. Tim Beck says he's done a very good job this year decision making at the line. Keeps it again. It's interesting, he had the stats, Matt. When we talked to Tim Beck, he said Taylor has checked at the line of scrimmage 15 times in our first two games. 9 times we got 5 yards or more on the play, and 3 times it went for a touchdown.
John, I think that's huge for an offense and a young quarterback. And keep in mind, it's only his second year. And yes, he had a lot of success, but running it the whole show, seeing the whole picture, and then making the right decisions, that is big. He's done a good job with that.
Third down and 8. Washington in the first two games had allowed their opponents to convert on third down 70% of the time. Worst third down defense in the country. The pitch to Burkhead. There's a third down stop with authority. Justin Glenn stepping in for Nate Felder at free safety today. Just stood up Burkhead a couple of yards short of the first down. And much improved third down defense today for Washington. Nebraska 0 for 3 on third down.
Yeah, this is a big hit. That's a great job of Glenn getting off the block. He got off the block and shed him, stuck Burkhead right in the chest. Really well done.
Jason Williams back for the punt from Brett Maher.
Wow.
A bomb. Williams watched it bounce inside the 10. What a kick by Brett Maher. There is a flag down on the play.
That was a missile, wasn't it? That thing turned over and it just carried.
Against Nebraska, Dave Whitvoet.
During the kick, holding on the kicking team. That penalty is going to be accepted. 10 yards at the previous spot, and will re-kick.
You saw the official there looking to the sideline to Steve Sarkisian saying,
"That's the dumbest question I've ever seen. Do you want them to re-kick? No, we'll just have them punt at 70 yards and be okay with that. We'll start inside our 10.
Because that was a bomb, man. That was a shot.
Yeah, we'll have him punt it over again.
Sure, take it back. You know, when you're watching punters, when you see the nose of that ball, when it is straight and not and the back end is up, and it'll just carry.
We're told they were going to mark it at the 12, so it would have been a 56-yard punt. Very little wind in the stadium on a cool and overcast afternoon with intermittent drizzle and fog. It's 58 degrees. And chilly here for several days. This one not as well kicked or very well covered as Kaysen Williams drags tacklers out to the 46-yard line. P.J. Mangieri, the long snapper, made the tackle. 16-yard return. This week on ESPN's Monday Night Football, Sam Bradford leads the St. Louis Rams into MetLife Stadium, where they'll take on Eli Manning and the New York Giants. Rams-Giants. ESPN's Monday Night Football, 8:30 Eastern, with coverage starting at 7, with Monday Night Countdown served by Applebee's.
Sean, that penalty was resulted in 35-yard difference in field position.
Whistle stopped the play before the handoff to Polk.
Timeout, Nebraska. Their second. This is a 32nd timeout.
We've seen them use two timeouts on defense. Carl Pellini said Washington costs you a lot of problems with their multiple formations, motions, and shifts, and that's been the case so far. Welcome back to Lincoln, Nebraska. Sean McDonough, Matt Millen, Heather Cox at sold-out Memorial Stadium. Nebraska leading 10-7. First and 10, Washington. Under 2 minutes to go in the first quarter, starting at their own 46. Chris Polk waited patiently for a hold. There's another flag down. He's down after a 2-yard gain in the arms of Lavonte David and Will Compton. Dave Whitvoet's had a little bit of a tough start here. See if he can point in the right direction.
During the play, holding, offense number 3. 10-yard penalty, repeat first down.
There you go. He's rolling now. One of the best officials in the country. You know, when Dave works a game, it's going to be very well officiated. James Johnson called for the holding penalty. Out of the gun on first and 20. Polk up the middle. Down at the 42. Tackled by Austin Cassidy. Let's send you back to the studio. Here's Robert.
Hey, Sean, the Longhorns adding to their lead at the Rose Bowl. Fozzie Whitaker. Little trick play here from in close. 14-0 Longhorns. The Boo Birds are out as the Bruins are trailing. 14-0. Start of the second quarter. Sean.
Yeah, there are some folks after Rick Neuheisel, as UCLA really hasn't found much of a rhythm since he returned to his alma mater as head coach. Chris Polk, the lone back. Price faked it to him. Throws on the run, incomplete. Was very well covered over the head of Jermaine Kearse. Josh Mitchell had the coverage.
Well covered on all three levels. This West Coast offense, when they play you, they try to hit you in different levels. Low, medium, high, and they put you in high-low situations. That particular time, the Nebraska defense had all the levels covered.
Third and 14, and loud noise from the sellout crowd. Price. Throws for an open receiver, and it's just a bit too long. Devin Aguilar was behind the defender, but Price had to throw it on the run and couldn't hit him in stride. Andrew Green had the coverage for Nebraska, but Aguilar was behind him.
See Andrew Green's eyes in the back, and that's why Aguilar ran right past him. You get put in a man situation, eyes stay on the man. That time he snuck a peek back inside. Unfortunately, it was an errant thrower. That would have been a big play.
Price started 5 for 5. He's 0 for 4 with an interception since. Wobbly punt by Rasp. It is muffed by Abdullah. On the ground, the Huskies say they have it, and the officials concur. A muff punt by Abdullah. And Desmond Trufant recovered it at the 22-yard line for Washington.
Yeah, he let it come in to his pads. He let it get into his pads, and then there's no give in your pads. Watch how he tries to cradle it. Hits him right in the chest. Bounces up. Going the other way.
They'll mark it at the 23. Final half minute of the first quarter. Washington trying to reclaim the lead. Price throws a bullet for a first down near the 10. James Johnson tackled by Josh Mitchell.
Sean, that is a perfect example of what we were speaking about early in Price's ability to see the whole field. It's designed to go out here. Watch his eyes. He looks down. There's no coverage. I mean, there's no one open. Coverage is perfect. He comes all the way back across the field and throws a bullet. That is really well done.
And it'll be the final play of the first quarter, 13-yard gain. The first down for Washington come back as they try to take the lead for the first time today. Up and down they went in the first quarter. It's Nebraska 10 and Washington 7. Wide open first quarter. Washington, Nebraska combining for 259 yards of offense, 137 from the Huskies, who are poised to take the lead.
Safarian Jenkins, that talented 6'6 freshman, he's a guy you have to keep your eyes on down in the red zone.
First and goal from the 10. On the delay, Chris Polk for three before he was stopped by Jared Crick. Senior's already graduated with a degree in history. We've talked to a lot of players over the years who graduated early and come back to play. A lot of times they only have to take one or two classes. Sometimes it's volleyball or introduction to coaching. Jared said, nope, the Big Ten makes you take 12 credit hours. So he has a relatively full academic load. Good for the Big Ten, by the way, on that score. Second and goal, Polk runs into Will Compton.
Sean, this defensive front, we talked about Jared Crick and Baker Steinkuhler earlier. Now they play what's called a two-gap technique, and it's a tough technique to play, but when they're playing it well, the linebackers will make a lot of tackles. And the two-gap technique is really no more than taking one guy on, and you're accounting for the A-gap and the B-gap, and that allows for your linebackers to be able to be free.
Third and goal. From the 6-yard line, Price seemed out of sorts from the get-go. Now throws out of sorts no more. Touchdown, Jermaine Kearse.
That one is delivered on the feet of Price.
Because that can't be the way they designed that.
It's not drawn up that way. This is really well done and great poise. Great awareness, and then his eyes down the field. He sees Kearse coming back. Sets his feet and the ball's right where it has to be.
There is life after Jake Locker. Keith Price so impressive through three games now. Washington took advantage of the muff punt by Amir Abdullah. Eric Polk's extra point has given Washington its first lead of the day, 4 points. Keith Price to Jermaine Kearse, 14-10, Washington. Keith Price has thrown two touchdown passes. Congratulated on the most recent one by Chris Polk. Both have gone to Jermaine Kearse. Washington kicks off with the lead. Flag down. Looked like Washington might have been offsides on the kickoff by Polk that went into the end zone. And it was down by Abdullah. Folks, the brother of Nick Folk, the former Cowboys kicker, now with the New York Jets, who kicked the game-winning field goal in the opener against Dallas.
kicking team, number 13. 5-yard penalty, re-kick.
Will Schamberger, longtime pal of Keith Price, went to high school together, grew up together, was the player who was offside. Let's take a look at our Pacific Life game summary. Mentioned plenty of offense in this game already. Washington averaging 7 yards per play, and Nebraska a little bit better than that.
Sean, you and I were talking a little bit about this in the break, but we had a chance to watch this same game a year ago with Jake Locker at quarterback. It's not even close. This offense has run so much better with Keith Price.
Jake Locke was the high first round draft choice of the Tennessee Titans. Folk picked it to the 1 yard line to Abdullah. Given the second chance, here he goes. Run down from behind, the ball's out. It's recovered by Tyler Legate. They're gonna mark Abdullah down, I believe. Back at the 34 yard line, tremendous speed by Justin Glenn, because Abdullah can fly. And there are very few in the country who are going to catch him from behind. But Glenn did to save the touchdown, and Abdullah still has not gotten up.
Yeah, Sean, it looked like Abdullah wanted to hit that extra gear right at about the 45-yard line. And look, that what he's laying down on the field for may have been what caught him. Nice
job.
So often
you see it, Matt, when you have to re-kick, this kind of thing happens. You think about Toledo punting last week. Second time Ohio State returned it for a touchdown. He was down. And Abdullah's up on his feet now and walking off under his own power.
He's an exciting freshman. Young, has the speed. He'll make a lot of big plays.
And Justin Glenn.
Justin Glenn walked him down. You are right.
Wow.
That is big time speed.
He set the record last week for kickoff returns in a game against Fresno State. He has 129 already today. That was a 66 yard return. Instead of starting at their own 20, Nebraska begins at the Washington 34. Taylor Martinez forced to pitch it to Burkhead, who spun away from Dennison and managed to gain 3. And it looked like it was going to be a loss. Everett Thompson made the tackle. Here's a look back. It was a tight game in the fourth quarter when Abdullah returned 100 yards to give Nebraska a 35-26 lead. Here's Burkhead running for a first down to the 23, tackled by Sean Parker and John Timu. Like they're looking at the right leg of Abdullah. Martinez, the option again. Late pitch to Burkhead, and he fielded it and went out of bounds. Martinez can be sloppy with the ball. Coming into today's game, he had fumbled 21 times in his 14 career starts at quarterback.
Well, when you play and defend the option, it's assignment football. One guy is assigned to the pitch man, one guy is assigned to the quarterback. Timu, that time the young freshman, was assigned to Martinez, Sean, and that hit right at the end and forced the bad pitch. That's
been one linebacker play today, critical for Washington. They have 2 first-year starters at outside linebacker. Martinez lofts it up, caught inside the 5. Aaron Green, touchdown. The officials conferred before giving the signal. Apparently Aaron Green stayed in bounds the whole trip. Martinez still not sure. It is a touchdown and the lead again for Nebraska.
Aaron Green just running a wheel route out of the backfield. Whoa. Take a good look at this, at the one step maybe. Right there.
They are going to take a look at it. Well, from there, to me, It's not conclusive that he's out of bounds. It even looks like there might be a little space between the side of his foot and the white sideline.
Doesn't look like there's enough there to be able to overturn it. And he does do a good job at the end of hitting the pylon, making sure that it's in. That looks close from that angle. Great effort, however. And nicely done.
By the way, is that you blowing up the picture, or are they doing that?
Yeah, they gave me a couple toys here.
Don't use it, because it's not helping at all. Hopefully, Jim Augustin in the booth has a clearer view. Nick Holt, the defensive coordinator, not happy at the moment.
Ruling on the field stands. Touchdown.
And the use of the word stands instead of the decision is confirmed. So I think when they say stands, usually means they don't have enough evidence to turn
exactly
it over.
And they probably used that blow up thing that we were giving them to
yes
be able to. Yeah, I'm
it was
sure
a huge
of it
help. The blurriness that showed nothing was a tremendous help. First career catch for Aaron Green, freshman from San Antonio, and goes for a touchdown of 25 yards.
ESPN's College Football on ABC, brought to you by AT&T. Get it faster with 4G. We think possible. And Dr. Pepper, with 23 flavors, Dr. Pepper is always one of a kind.
Look at the Larson Tractor Test and Power Museum here in Lincoln, founded in 1998. It has the world's most comprehensive collection of antique tractors and the performance data and literature used to certify the power, performance, and design of those tractors. And you were fired up when you saw the video from that
yeah
place.
Yeah, I was looking for one of mine. I got my international at home.
Brett Maher kicks off for Nebraska, down to Jesse Calvier at the 2-yard line. Has some room, still on his feet. And finally swung down at the 33 by Graham Stoddard.
Sean, let's take a look at this touchdown and see what happens. They're going to go to a roll to a cover three. He's going to come down, and then it's one deep, two deep, three deep. Now, the rules change down here inside this, close to the red zone. And this is the key right here. Jamora, knowing that this corner has got to honor that receiver, Jamora has to carry the wheel route all the way through. He's not going to get the help from the corner that you would normally, and that results in a touchdown.
Keith Price under center. Handed it off to Jesse Callier, who went in motion. And a good open field tackle by Damian Stafford in his first year at Nebraska as a junior college transfer from California. The revamped secondary, they lost Prince Amukamara to the NFL draft, first round pick of the Giants. And we mentioned they're playing today without Alfonso Dennard, still out with a quad injury. That young secondary, the biggest concern of the Nebraska defensive coaches at this point in the year. Price pressured right from the snap. Had Safarian Jenkins coming open, but he couldn't run down the errant throw from Price.
And Nebraska gives you some physical play right up front. They come with the blitz inside. That's Will Compton, 51. And boy, he takes on that block and forces Price to have to get out of the pocket. I got to tell you, Price had the wherewithal to be able to get out and have a chance to make a play.
And Terrence Moore delivered the hit to Price. Third down and 8, Washington. 11 and a half to go till halftime. Play clock running out. Price snapped it with 1. Given time, deep throw, caught. First down and much more. James Johnson into Nebraska territory at the 42-yard line.
That never happens if they don't pick up the corner blitz. This is really, really well done. See the corner coming off the side. Tackle picks him up, and because he's protected, he's able to find him down the field. That's Eric Kohler, the right tackle, number 75. Really did a great job in this league. As an offensive lineman, if you can't see, you can't play. He did a fantastic job.
23-yard gain as a result on the completion of James Johnson. High formation now. And another play action pass Dumped off to Chris Culp. Pulled down by Andrew Green, and he lunged to the 32-yard line. There is a flag down at the 28-yard line. This Big Ten crew throwing a lot of flags here in the first half.
Funny, Sean, Nick Holt, the defensive coordinator for the Washington Huskies, he saw it before anybody. He started calling it. I was watching him on the sideline, and then the field judge, he gave it a toss.
Personal foul, face mask, defense number 11, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Andrew Green called for the face mask. But actually
really
it was 51,
Compton,
they
yeah.
announced the wrong number. Green made the tackle. And then when Compton came in to help, wasn't much of one, but he did it. And that's all that matters. The ball goes to the 17-yard line, first and 10. These two offenses marching up and down the field, taking advantage of mistakes by the opposition. Jesse Callier again turning the corner, but whistle stopped the play. Illegal procedure will be the call against Washington.
False start, offense, number 88. 84, correction. 5-yard penalty, the down remains first.
88, 84, what's the difference? Four digits. I'm just saying.
Starting to be reminded of that commercial of the football ref. Want to get away?
Oh, boy.
Dave has wanted a couple of do-overs today, I think. From the 22, first and 15, the throw too high. And Jermaine Kearse was surrounded by Nebraska Cornhuskers. Not anybody right on his hip, but that was a dangerous throw, and it might be why Price threw it high and away.
Price wanted to have that one back, but I got to tell you, Steve Sarkisian, he is calling an excellent game, and they're using a lot of crossing routes. Crossing routes take a lot of time, and so that puts a lot of pressure on your offensive line and also your quarterback if he has to buy time.
Jonathan Amosa, the fullback, went in motion. Again, pressure right up the middle from Crick. Price got away and throws it away. He avoided a huge loss. They better start blocking some of these Nebraska defenders coming right up the middle into the face of Price. He retreated 19 yards before he was able to throw it away.
Yeah, he's right inside. I mean, it's a blown protection. Crick takes advantage of the blown protection, but Price does a fantastic job to get out of that to set up this third and maybe 15, but he gives them a chance with his feet.
Price will want to be careful. They're at least in field goal range here to tie the game. Timeout Washington.
What an impressive kid.
You mentioned the terrific job Steve Sarkisian does calling the plays, and that's been true back to his time at USC. It's a pretty good combination they have. The offensive coordinator is Doug Nussmeier. Steve Sarkisian, when he was in college at BYU, threw for over 7,700 yards in 2 years and was the WAC most valuable player. Doug Nussmeier at Idaho threw for over 10,000 yards in his career. So you have two quarterbacks who are pretty adept at diagnosing defenses and calling plays.
And all they want is for their quarterback to just hit the open receiver, and he's done a great job of that here today. He's used his feet to get him out of some trouble. But you really like the game that Sarkisian's calling. He has Nebraska off balance. He's taking advantage of the young secondary. And those crossing routes are tough to cover.
Let's see what he dials up now on third down and 15. Just a four-man rush. Price hit from behind. And did well to hang on to the football as he got rocked by Jared Crick.
Crick was relentless. He comes upfield. You see him on the top of your screen. But then he just keeps on coming. The motor made the sack.
Price literally has a crick in his neck right now. 41-yard field goal try to tie the game. Eric Folk's kick is good. And he's still perfect this year in field goals, 5 for 5. 290 pounds of Jared Crick. What a wallop on Keith Price. Let's see if he's still smiling after that. Yes, he is. apiece. Let's check in with Heather Cox.
Sean, on the last kickoff return, you saw Amir Abdullah out there and get injured. He did have that right ankle heavily taped. Several teammates came over to the training table to express their concerns. Since then, he's been testing it. I was told he would return to action. Certainly not out there right now. Remember, he had a 100-yard kickoff return for a touchdown a week ago against Fresno State. The Huskers would like to see him out there.
And Tim Marlowe and Jamal Turner back to receive it. It'll be Turner this time. Bringing the Eric Folk kickoff. He's down at the 22-yard line. When we talk at the top of the telecast, job one is stopping Taylor Martinez on the run. He's done a nice job throwing today, Matt.
Yes, he really has. You know, Sean, he does not have an NFL arm. His mechanics are not very good, but he's very effective. He knows, he sees the open receiver, and today he's been getting him there.
Thrown two touchdown passes and going deep on the first play from scrimmage and a double coverage and broken up. Intended for Kenny Bell. The fans want a flag, but it was outstanding defense by Quentin Richardson and Desmond Trufant.
Sean, here's one of the reasons I said earlier, you know, he doesn't have an NFL arm. His ball hangs in the air. He throws it straight up in the air. And then when it hangs there, that allows for defenders to close the cushion.
Quincy Anunua was open and wanted the ball. Now they've worked to change the mechanics of Taylor Martinez, but he just hasn't been comfortable changing his throwing motion. He runs out of bounds at the 26-yard line. Here's Robert Flores with an update.
Hey, Sean, UCLA is on the board against the Longhorns, down 21-0. Made a switch at quarterback, then Derek Coleman, whoop-de-dern-doo, scores in from the one. They're down, however, 21-7. Notre Dame leading Michigan State 21-10 at South Bend.
Irish looking for their first win of the year. Two very tough losses. Third and six. Nebraska hasn't converted on third down yet, 0 for 3. Martinez given plenty of time, has his receiver Jamal Turner across midfield and wrestled down by Sean Parker at the 47 of Washington. First and 10 Nebraska, 27-yard gain.
This is where Taylor Martinez is at his best. He throws the intermediate ball pretty well. He doesn't have the greatest delivery, but he was right on the money right there. Turner can fly.
Rex Burkhead with a flag thrown by the referee, Dave Whitvoet. In the area, you'd expect a holding call. Desmond Trufant chopped him down with help from Andrew Hudson.
Holding, offense. 10-yard penalty, repeat for sound.
Sean, let's go back and look at Taylor Martinez's mechanics, what we were talking about earlier. Watch, his step is out, and then he throws this way. He has the low arm. It's not a three-quarter over-the-top delivery. I'm sorry, over-the-top delivery. It's not even three-quarter. He kind of pushes it from inside. It's ugly, but effective.
One of the stories of this game, there are three starters on the offensive line today for Nebraska who came there as walk-ons. The center and both starting guards all came to Lincoln as walk-ons. Martinez had to pull it down, got pushed out of bounds by Haole Jamora. The center, Mike Caputo, become a very good starter, number 58, but he came as a walk-on, now on scholarship. Both guards are walk-ons, not on scholarship. Sung-hoon Choi in for the injured Andrew Rodriguez today, and Spencer Long, the Right guard also a walk-on. Choi's a great story. He's from Seoul, South Korea. Came to Lincoln, Nebraska as an eighth grader. Get an education in this country. His dad is a researcher at the University of Nebraska. He'd never played football, never even seen football when he got over here to go to high school. Martinez got belted like a pinata by Jamora and Alameda Ta'amu.
Ta'amu, he puts the finishing touch on this tackle, Sean. And that's what they were talking about getting hits on this quarterback. When you have the opportunity, try to get a big hit on him.
Third down and long, 17 to go from their own 46. 7 minutes left, first half. We're tied at 17. And the pistol look with Burkhead right behind Martinez. They come on a blitz. Martinez get hits by Trufant. The ball's in the air and incomplete. Trufant, the blitzer, hit Martinez as he went to throw. The ball went straight up in the air. Was nearly picked off. Falls as an incompletion and a punt to come by Nebraska.
You're going to watch Trufant right here. They're going to bring the pressure. That is incumbent on the quarterback to know that it's coming. And then Burkhead just does not do a very good job. Trufant does do a good job. Gets the hit.
Last time Nebraska started three walk-ons or former walk-ons on the offensive line was 1988. Maher punts. Very quiet crowd here now. Devin Aguilar fields it at the 10. And brings it back 9 yards. Pushed out by Tim Marlowe. Tomorrow morning on ESPN, don't miss Sunday NFL Countdown presented by IBM. Its new time is 10 a.m. Eastern. Boomer, TJ, Coach Ditka, Chris Carter, Keyshawn Johnson, and Bill Parcells with 3 hours of insights and analysis to get you ready for all of Sunday's NFL action. And ESPN2 is the new Sunday morning lineup, starting with Outside the Lines, hosted by Bob Lee at 10 a.m. The sports reporters at 10:30, then SportsCenter and Fantasy Football Now. First and 10, Washington. Huskies from their own 19. Holt to the 21 for two. It'll be second and 8. Jared Crick there again, playing very much like the preseason All-American he was.
It was fun talking to him yesterday. He's a big, powerful kid. As soon as he walked in the door, we talked to him a year ago, and you could see he's gotten bigger physically. He was thicker in his upper body through his arms, and he got faster.
Yeah, he's 290 pounds. There's not a lot of fat on that body. Second and 8. Polk off right tackle. Fights for an extra yard to the 24. Third down and 5 to come.
Now, if you take a good look at Jared Crick, there's a couple things that really jump off the tape with you. First of all, he can play a lot of different positions. He can play defensive end. He can play tackle. He can play nose. He's got strong hands, and he sheds blockers, gets rid of blockers really well. But the thing that sets him apart for a big man at 295 pounds, he can really burst.
He ran the 400 meters in high school in track when he was 250 pounds. He was the anchor of their 4x4 relay team in high school. Completion by Price on 3rd and 5. They convert to Devin Aguilar, coming off a great game last week against Hawaii when he had 5 receptions for 131 yards. Doug Nussmeier said it was the best game of Aguilar's career.
Well, Aguilar is able to get inside position on this young secondary because this offensive line is protecting extremely well. They've protected well, and Price has thrown the ball well.
First catch of the day for Aguilar, good for 7 and a first down. Jesse Callier, the running back now from the 31. Trying to bounce outside, got away from Levante David. And a good move on the perimeter to get away from Josh Mitchell before Damian Stafford finally got him on the ground at the 37-yard line. A hard-earned 6 yards. And Stafford, who made the tackle, is going to have to come out of the ballgame.
I still think right now you got to look for that freshman tight end. He's a player.
And they come quickly to the line of scrimmage, trying to catch Nebraska off guard. Polk got very near the first down marker. Looks like they're going to mark it just short. Driven back by Cameron Meredith and Levante David. Will Compton also at the bottom of the pile, as he so often is. Third down and less than a yard. We're under 4 minutes to go now in the first half. Up and down game. These two teams marching up and down the field. Tied at 17. Polk has the first down. Across the 41. Ned Polk lined up as the fullback there in front of Jesse Callier.
This is good patience. You're going to watch Crick comes off the ball and gets pressure right up inside. And then Polk allows that to happen and just kind of slides to the left in between Meredith and Crick.
Stafford's going to the locker room. They're already playing without Alfonso Dennard, their star cornerback. Now one of their starting safeties goes down, at least for the moment. Callier slipped as he tried to turn the corner and lost a couple back to the 40.
You know, when you watch this offense of the Washington Huskies, you'll see a lot of shifts and a lot of motions. And what they're trying to do, when you see that, they are just trying to determine what you're in, and they're trying to move you like a chess piece. They motion you out to try to take you away and from inside. And Sarkisian on the sideline sees everything, and he orchestrates the whole deal.
Polk out of the game with a cramp. Jory Fulgerson comes in at running back. Compton came on a blitz. Price on a receiver for a short gain. It's James Johnson, Jr., who had only one reception all of last season. He was plagued by injuries. Josh Mitchell made the tackle.
Well, so what Carl Pellini's done in this last series is he's brought pressure, and he's forcing Price to have to make a quick decision, which kind of negates all the motion.
Carl Pellini said every time they shift or motion, it changes what we're doing on defense. So there are many more sideline adjustments than usual when you play against Washington. Meredith, a good rush, didn't get there, and the pass is incomplete. Intended for Aguilar, a little behind him. Meredith didn't get there, but that strong pass rush did force a quick and errant throw. The brothers Pellini, masterminds of this Nebraska defense, which has been one of the best in the country since they came to Lincoln. It was one of the worst in the country the year before they got here. Final days of the Bill Callahan regime. Kyle Rask punts. Fair catch signaled. Ball hit the ground. It's a Washington ball for the moment. They run it in. Is it going to count? There's a flag down. It was run in by Jamal Kearse. Tim Marlowe was calling for a fair catch. He stumbled. Looked like the ball might have hit him. There's also a flag on the play. These officials have already had a bunch to sort out today, and here's another that'll test them.
Well, the Washington sideline, as soon as they saw it, they all started pointing.
Kick catch interference, kicking team, number 31, 15 yards, first down.
Court Dennison called for interference, and Steve Sarkisian doesn't like it.
1-4-9.
Oh, that's a bad call. A really bad call. We're back in Lincoln, Nebraska. Big call here by the officials. Marlowe trying to make a fair catch. Stumbled after he contacted his own man. The ball hits Marlowe, but Court Dennison was called for kick catch interference.
That's a poor call, Sean.
Yeah, there's no more halo. They used to have that halo where you had a protected circle around the punt returner. That doesn't exist anymore. Ball comes out to the 41-yard line. Taylor Martinez is the quarterback and throws. Caught by Kenny Bell. The rule book says it is an interference foul if the kicking team contacts the potential receiver before or simultaneous to his first touching the ball. That didn't happen. He never touched him.
No, in fact, he avoided him and allowed Marlowe to be able to make a catch if he wanted to. Marlowe tripped on his teammate, and then the ball did hit him. That should be Washington's ball from that spot.
Newell also says the receiver must be given an unimpeded opportunity to catch the kick, but
which
was
he
unimpeded. He had the chance to catch it. Well, anyway, they play on.
And you got a third down right here. It's a big third down.
After the incomplete pass intended for Bell again. Third down and one from midfield. 1:38 to go in the half. Tied at 17. Just one timeout left for Nebraska. They've used two on defense. Martinez carries for the first down. They'll stop the clock to move the chains. And the line of scrimmage will be the 46. Ole Jamora made the tackle. He's their best defensive end.
Just a sophomore, good-looking young player. Can get up the field, pretty athletic. This will go against the offense.
False start, offense, number 78. 5-yard penalty, the down remains first.
Marcel Jones. Backup offensive lineman in there now for Nebraska. He has starter's ability. He's been bothered by injuries in fall camp and into the early part of this year. Martinez throws quickly and a nice catch made by Kyler Reed. First down after the acrobatic grab by the tight end out of Kansas City, Kansas.
Well, that is a great decision and a quick. They got that ball out quick, did Martinez. Reed made the catch.
19-yard gain from the 32. Martinez, another quick throw. And a good catch by Quincy Anunua, their leading receiver for the year coming in. His first catch today. The marker of the 28, pickup of four. He went out of bounds. Apparently did not. 44 seconds, the clock running. They throw to the sideline again. Ben Cotton, the tight end, is out of bounds at the 20. Refused to go down with Justin Glenn trying to wrestle him to the ground.
This is good vision and awareness by Martinez. He's in his wheelhouse right here when he's throwing these intermediate balls, short to intermediate balls. They gave him the coverage. They're backed off. And he sees it right away and is getting the ball out quick.
They're in field goal range, but they'd like seven. Each team has led in this game. Now they're tied at 17. A blitz. Martinez locks it up again and almost intercepted by Desmond Trufant in the back of the end zone.
Sean, he's at his best in the short to intermediate range. His deep ball, it hangs in the air too much. Now he's right here. You're at the 20-yard line, so it's not like you're throwing a real deep ball. You can afford to throw it a little, you know, you can get it quicker and take the trajectory off a little bit.
Martinez pulls it down, throws, incomplete. Intended for Anunua again, the far sideline with Gregory Ducray. Plays in a lot of nickel and dime situations in coverage. So it's third down and 10 for Nebraska, the Washington 20. Telling the fans to make some noise. There are a few Washington fans here among the 85,000 plus. Martinez crossed the line of scrimmage, got two, perhaps two and a half, and that's all. They'll likely let the clock run down, call a timeout, and try to kick a field goal in the final seconds of this half. Everett Thompson made the tackle.
Well, Sean, one of the things that this Husky defense wanted to be able to do was to be sure tackling team. Today, so far, they've done that. They've had some pretty good tackles in the open field here today.
So Nebraska used all of its timeouts here in the first half. They'll try to take the lead again. led 7-0, 10-7.
To me, it's been a good first half. It's been actually pretty well played. I think both teams' strengths have performed. Martinez, they said, hey, he's going to have to throw the ball to beat us, and he's done a pretty good job here in the first half, and we've seen what Keith Price can do as well. It's not been a real big day for the running games. Both of them won it. Huskies at 66 yards and the Huskers at 89 yards.
Here's Brett Maher in to try the field goal. He's 1-for-1 today from 45 yards.
Washington.
Washington calls the timeout. Everett Thompson of Washington blocked 2 extra points by Hawaii last week. He's on the field there, number 92 for Washington. The new season of Dancing with the Stars premieres Monday, 8 Eastern, 7 Pacific on ABC. Most surprising cast ever. It includes the soccer goalie, Hope Solo, Los Angeles Laker Ron Artest, who I believe just legally changed his name to Meta World Peace.
Yes, I saw that.
You don't want to miss it. He's predicting he's going to win it, regardless of his name. Dancing with the Stars Monday at 8 Eastern. Yeah, that's a nice goal. If you're going to change your name, a nice goal for world peace. Maher kicks the field goal. 35-yarder. He's still perfect on the season, and Nebraska will take a 3-point lead into the locker room. Martinez threw for 145 and 2 touchdowns. Ran for 52 yards. Here's Heather Cox.
Sean, thanks so much. Coach, you're a running team that came out passing the ball. How have you had so much success throwing it?
Well, we've just taken what they've been giving us. You know, I think Tim's called a good game so far. You know, they're loading the box at times. You know, it's a little bit of cat and mouse, but I think we're executing pretty well.
The point of emphasis all week has been on defense. Where does it need to improve in the second half?
Well, they're all over the place formationally, and our kids just got to settle down and play their roles. And they threw a lot of stuff at us in that first half. I think our guys settled down as the half went on.
We'll let you get to the locker room. Thanks, Coach Bellini.
His team leads for the fourth time in this game. Back and forth they went through that first half. At the break, Nebraska 20, Washington 17. Coming up, stay tuned for a complete halftime report right after these messages. Back in Lincoln, Nebraska, as Washington came back onto the field for the start of the second half, Steve Sarkisian ran straight to Dave Whitboat, the referee, probably wanted an explanation about what happened near the end of the half. It's a very key play in this football game. They were tied at 17 with under 2 minutes to go in the half, Nebraska and Washington, when the Washington Huskies went to punt. Tim Marlowe, the deep man for Nebraska, signaled for a fair catch as he starts to approach the ball, as you'll see. He stumbles into one of his teammates. The ball hit Marlowe, and Washington recovered. The ball got run in the end zone by the Huskies. Court Dennison was called for interference. Clearly a bad call, and Matt, a big play, because even though they could have advanced it, Washington would have had the ball at the 25-yard line going in and a chance to take the lead. Instead, Nebraska got the ball, the penalty yardage added on. They went down and kicked the go-ahead field goal. That's a big swing.
That's a huge swing, and I think the big thing there is you can't do anything about it now, so you have to move on. Court Dennison was called for a penalty that didn't exist. But, hey, sometimes that's just the way it goes in this game.
It was not kick-catch interference, even though that was the call. You wonder if Marlowe's stumble
on his teammate
confused the officials. It was his teammate that caused him to stumble on that collision. Brett Maher kicks off. Bishop Sankey, a true freshman, takes the knee. And we head down to Heather Cox.
Sean, this won't surprise you. Steve Sarkisian still frustrated about that interference call. I talked to Sark as well as the officials. The explanation they were very adamant about is, yes, the Nebraska returner was interfered with. Now, what Sarkisian wants to do in the second half is establish the run game more, go to Chris Polk while still taking shots when they're there. Now, guys, that will be tough. All three starters in the Husky backfield are struggling. Fullback Jonathan Amosa has a sore knee. Polk and Collier, both running backs, are cramping heavily. They took fluids at halftime. We'll see how they do in the second half.
Polk on the field to start the second half. Rushed for 57 yards in the opening half on 12 carries. Heath Price, after faking to Polk, wants a deep ball. Double coverage down there. Incomplete. Intended for Jermaine Kearse with Damian Stafford and Ciante Evans in double coverage.
Well, through the first half, Keith Price, I thought, has played a pretty good game. And he's used his feet to buy some time. He's hit the open receivers. He'd like to have a couple back. There's one he had earlier down the sideline that he just missed, flat out missed the guy. But I think Keith Price is one of the reasons that they're in this, where they're at in this game right now, because he's pretty much in control of this offense.
And just to put the period on what Heather said, the officials can be as adamant as they want.
It wasn't wrong.
Kick catch interference. Polk drives to the 24, and then he got driven back by Lavonte David. Help from Andrew Green. Third and six upcoming for Washington.
You know, Sean, early in the game, we saw a lot of the freshman tight end, number 88.
Austin Seferian Jenkins.
There you go, Seferian Jenkins. And since that time, he's kind of been absent from this offense. He is a big piece of the puzzle here, and they've gotten away from him.
He's caught one pass. They have thrown in his direction a couple of other times. Third and six. Nebraska brings a blitz. Price has time, and it's dropped by Devin Aguilar. That inside position on Josh Mitchell, it looked like a good throw. But Aguilar couldn't squeeze it. A three and out to begin the half for Washington.
Now this one's completely on Aguilar. It's a double slant inside. You have a zero coverage. Everybody's going. It was a blitz inside. They picked it up. Aguilar has to make that catch, and he has a first down.
There's Kyle Rasp. Better kick this time. Rex Burkhead back deep. He gets leveled immediately, and the flag is thrown. Desmond Trufant right there. I mean, that was almost as if to say, if you're going to call it on us, at least we're going to earn it. And now there's another flag. It might be on the sideline. That was thrown right in front of the Husky coaches. Still seething about that call that was significant at the end of the half.
I didn't see a fair catch signal. And it was a bang bang play. I don't know what you want the defender to do.
Again,
I mean, he
no
was right
halo.
On him.
All you have to do is give him an unimpeded chance to make the catch. He
caught the ball.
Made the catch. Trufant saying it was not a fair catch signal. He's holding his hand above his head and
kick
waving
catch
no.
Interference. Kicking team, number six, 15 yard penalty, first down. After the play, sideline interference, delay of game, Washington. 5-yard penalty. First down.
Well, did he call for a fair catch?
No.
No. Catches the ball and then he gets hit.
To me, that's a good football play.
Mm-hmm. Again, there's no halo. Matter of fact, he slows down slightly at the end to let him make the catch. And there was no fair catch signal, so that wasn't what it was. I don't blame the sideline for drawing a flag. Yard line, Nebraska the ball for the first time in the second half. 3-point lead. Martinez tucks and runs. That bop down across midfield. Alameda Ta'amu with help from Court Dennison. Gain of about 7, second and 3 upcoming.
But Taylor Martinez has showed a couple things here to his intermediate game. The ball's coming out quick. He's seeing things. The run game has not really been where he's starred today, but he has shown some good toughness.
Jamal Turner gives Dennison a bit of a stiff arm as he goes out of bounds. Inside the 42-yard line, first down, Nebraska.
Sean, that kid right there, Jamal Turner, boy, he is going to be something because he can really scoop. He's exciting. He can get down the field quick, and he's at full speed in two steps. Just a freshman out of Arlington. He's exciting.
Came as a quarterback. Spent 3 days of spring ball as a quarterback. Then they realized they needed to get him on the field, and he wasn't going to play behind Martinez. They moved him to wide receiver, and he is making an impact. Martinez belted down at the 40-yard line. He got two. Dennison again with help from Haole Jamora.
Court Dennison's played himself a heck of a football game here today. He was very active in the first half. He's active here at the start of the second half.
Three receivers to the left of Martinez. Again out of the pistol set with Rex Burkhead behind him. Four people signaling toward Martinez on that sideline as he looked over there. Slides down at the 34-yard line. It'll be third down and two. John Timu made the tackle. Looks like they want to get up to the line quickly, but now they do bring substitutes onto the field on offense.
Good decision by Martinez. He saw that the coverage was off. You heard Bo Pelini talking to Heather at halftime. He said, we're just going to take what this defense has given us. So that's a perfect example. Martinez seeing it and taking it.
Pitch back to Burkhead. Little shake and bake to get the first down. Then he powered his way at the end to the 27-yard line. Justin Glenn and John T. move the tackle. First down, a gain of seven.
Burkhead gets this on his own, just with some spin. When they're going to crowd the box inside, you run the edge. You run the edge, you force them to have to declare on the quarterback and then get up the field with the pitch. That hurts with Court Dennison out.
Yeah, it looked like somebody rolled up on his leg there as he was trying to be involved in the tackle. The leader of that defense gets them lined up properly. Senior middle linebacker on the sideline at the moment. Burkhead running room to the left, inside the 20, inside the 15, down near the 12-yard line. Justin Glenn made another tackle. 15 yards for Burkhead, a junior from Plano, Texas, and another Nebraska first down.
Good vision, good decision.
Burkhead running right, then left. And Justin Glenn there again. Boy, they're without Nate Fellner, their starting safety, but Glenn's been all over the field.
He really has. He's showed some great speed as well, Sean. Able to close on some things. But you'd like that your front seven is making the tackles and not anybody out of your back four.
Seven tackles for the safety, Justin Glenn, today. On second and six, Martinez kept it. And he's down near the 1 yard line. Sean Parker saved the touchdown. It'll be first and goal for Nebraska, trying to go up by two scores.
This time you're going to watch Martinez at the end of this play. He is smelling end zone and wants to get in. He lowers his shoulder. Look at this. That's not smart for your starting quarterback.
He's tough, 6'1", 200 pounds. Neither team has had a two-score advantage today in this back-and-forth game. Largest lead for Nebraska, 7.
Nebraska, their first.
And the largest lead for Washington today has been 4. Back in Lincoln, Nebraska, 85,110 the attendance, 314th consecutive sellout dating back to November of 1962. They're watching a good one. First and goal, Nebraska. Leading by 3, opening minutes of the third quarter. Trying to go up by two scores. High formation. Rex Burkhead. Touchdown.
Short yardage and goal line is where you really test the toughness, not only of your overall team, but of your offensive line. And the key to being tough is coming off the ball with great leverage. Nebraska did it really well right here. It's just a tough yard, but Burkhead finishes it.
course, it started with 20 yards of penalties against Washington. After their punt, 9 plays, 56 yards for Nebraska. 6 of the 9 plays went 6 yards or more. Rex Burke had the touchdown, Brett Maher the extra point. And it's the largest lead of the game for either team, 10 points. Nebraska ahead, 27-17. Let's look at our Pacific Life game summary. Taylor Martinez, 226 total yards. He's thrown for a couple of scores. He's rushed for 74. Keith Price has also thrown touchdown passes, 2 of them to Jermaine Kearse. Kearse had only 4 catches combined in the 2 games against Nebraska. Last year has had 3 today, including the 2 touchdowns.
And it's a shame, Sean, and I'll leave it go after this, that those 2 interference calls, my opinion, were the wrong calls. And I think that's had a huge
impact on the game.
It really has.
At the end of the half and the beginning of this half. And both of them lousy calls. Now the ball booted around inside the 5-yard line. It's still free. Bishop Sankey and Kevin Smith, a couple of very inexperienced players back there, and Nebraska has it at the 1-yard line. Sankey originally tried to play it. They started booting it around. He's a true freshman. Kevin Smith's a sophomore. They never did gain possession of it completely. And Nebraska will be given the ball at the 1-yard line. Sankey dropped it, then kicked it. And Smith tried to help him. They never did get it. Matthew May recovered for Nebraska. And the Huskies have no one to blame but themselves on that one.
That's the first time Keith Price is not smiling.
Ruling on the field that the kick was muffed, came out of the end zone, and was recovered by Nebraska on the 1-yard line. The previous play is under further review.
And it's interesting because we went for some clarification at the half. The replay booth could not have overturned the flag that was thrown for kick catch interference. They can't review that. That's a judgment call. They could have reviewed whether the punt struck Tim Marlowe in the first half if they had asked for help about that. So I don't really know what they're reviewing here. Maybe they're trying to see if the ball was recovered in the end zone and should have been a touchdown. Well, it looks like May has it and he's not in the end zone, and he kind of rolls in. It looks like the officials spotted it in the right place.
After further review, the ruling on the field is confirmed.
He said adamantly. So first and goal and a chance to take a 17-point lead for Nebraska. Rex Burkhead again. Touchdown. Two touchdowns for Burkhead in 9 seconds. And what had been a tight game throughout is on the verge of being a 17-point lead for Nebraska with a lot of time left to go. 10:09 remaining, third quarter. Brett Maher, who was the holder for Alex Henry last year, kicks the extra point. 34-17. Nebraska has the lead.
College football on ABC, brought to you by Pacific Life. For insurance, annuities, and investments, choose Pacific Life, the power to help you succeed. And Hotels.com. Be smart. Book smart.
Well, if you like licorice, Lincoln is the place to be. Licorice International's headquarters are right here in Nebraska's capital city. They have more than 160 types of licorice from 12 countries. We sampled a lot of that yesterday. It was yummy.
May or may not have had a few pieces.
Well, Sankey is not back for this kickoff after the disaster a moment ago. Kevin Smith fields this one. Started at the 2 and does not make the 20. Special teams nightmare lately for Washington. Eric Martin with outstanding coverage as he was full speed ahead.
Big Eric Martin, number 46, shows up in a foul mood and lets him know. He just runs right past the runner, just drills him. That's really well done.
He's a defensive end, a fan favorite. Many believe he should see more playing time on the defensive line. So plenty of work to do now for the Huskies. Chris Polk, the ball's out. Knocked out by Damian Stafford and recovered by Jason Ingram, but they're going to roll him down. And that was close. It's a 3-yard gain instead of another turnover.
This is a nice hit. Just a safety dropping down and a boom.
Crowd wants him to review this play. Looked like the ball came out after his elbow and hit the ground.
Yeah.
Empty backfield for Price on second down. Running for his life. Back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. And a little shove from Terrence Moore. Well, even after that last touchdown, we had a shot during the commercial break. Price is over there winking and smiling at his teammates as if to say, okay, we're still all right. Let's go.
Yeah, he's got that part down. He's got it nailed. And I think he's one of those guys that he's so effervescent and so confident. I think he's one of those guys that's easy to follow. You know, and his leadership skills will build off of that trait alone.
There's an injured Husky. Looks like another cramp situation. Jermaine Curse caught their 2 touchdowns in the first half. Bothered by an ankle injury that cost him most of their season opener against Eastern Washington. And he's walking off under his own power. Heather.
Sean, with all the fumbles and all the trouble we've had with these players holding onto the football, it's certainly worth noting that since halftime, it has been misting constantly. It is very damp, very wet on the field. Even though you can't see the raindrops, there's a constant mist on the field.
Temperature in the high 50s. Been unusually cool here for several days, as has been the case in a lot of the country. Blitz off the corner. Price got away from it, throws it up for grabs, and it's incomplete. James Johnson, the intended receiver. And that's the kind of throw that gets a wide receiver hurt.
Well, Austin Cassidy was closing on that ball, and you're right, Sean. And he tries to sneak this one in. But James Johnson, ooh, boy. Actually, Johnson did a nice job of not allowing Cassidy to make this interception. Ugh. That's a tough one.
Austin Cassidy has already graduated. Kind of a slacker in the classroom. Degree in psychology. 3.91 GPA. He said he got a couple of A minuses. Said his mother was more upset than that. She's an accounting professor at Texas A&M. Nancy Cassidy. His dad is the director of football operations at Texas A&M. Tim Cassidy been here at Nebraska for a while and then went back to work at the A&M football program. Nice kid. We enjoyed our visit with, we should say, nice young man.
Yeah, and a good player.
Everyone's a kid to us. We get to be our age. Kyle Rasp. Line drive putt. Rex Burkhead had plenty of room to catch it. And goes to the 42-yard line. Princeton Fui Maono made the tackle. 40-yard punt, 19-yard run back by Burkhead. Tomorrow afternoon on ESPN, The chase for the Sprint Cup begins with Jimmy Johnson eyeing his sixth straight title. The regular season points leaders Kyle Busch and Kevin Harvick, a four-time NASCAR champ Jeff Gordon, knocked JJ from his perch. Find out starting tomorrow. The chase for the NASCAR Sprint Cup with the Geico 400 from Chicago. Coverage starts with NASCAR Countdown, presented by Napa tomorrow at 1 Eastern Time. Raylan Hurd is in a tailback. He takes the pitch. Gets to the 38. Court Dennison back on the field, made the tackle.
Another tackle for Dennison and another talented freshman. And they just keep bringing the young ones out with more speed than the last.
They have three true freshmen behind Burkhead: Abdullah, Hurd, and Aaron Green. Hurd again. All the way down to the 14-yard line. Gregory Dupre made the stop.
We talked about all the speed, but you saw right there runner's patience. That's really well done. He just gets behind the block of Inouye. Just kind of waits for it to develop.
25-yard gain. Raylan Hurd to the right. Good tackle by Sean Parker. Held it to a 1-yard gain. Raylan Hurd's from Youngstown, Ohio, out of Cardinal Mooney High School, same school that produced the Pelini brothers, Bo and Carl, and Tim Beck, the offensive coordinator, also out of Cardinal Mooney. Pump fake by Martinez, and he throws an interception. Ruled incomplete. Justin Glenn says he had it. The officials say no, it hit the ground. Side judge Frank Steratore had a good look at it.
I don't know about that one. He's
the
under it.
Under the ball there.
Oh, there it hits.
And then it hits.
It hits. That's good call.
Third down and 8. And Martinez looks to the sideline for helpful signals. Midway through the third quarter. Play clock running out. Martinez throws incomplete. Had a man open. It was Kyler Reed about 3 yards into the end zone. He missed him.
Martinez had time to make that throw. You're right, Sean. He just missed him. You know, somebody here on this defense for Washington is going to have to make a play, and offensively, they're going to have to get some consistency, because this thing right now, you can feel, is just slipping away.
Little special teams plays, controversial calls, and really seem to have changed the game. Maher. A 29-yard field goal. He's 3 for 3 today. It's a 20-point lead for Nebraska.
National Powers Tangle in Tallahassee as the top-ranked Sooners take on the Noles. Oklahoma, Florida State. Tonight, 8 p.m. Eastern on ABC. College football lives here.
Huge matchup tonight, one of the biggest games of the young football season, 1 versus 5. Here it's number 11 Nebraska trying to go to 3-0. Washington is also 2-0. It was a tight game in the first half. It has opened up a bit. Nebraska leading by 20 as Maher picks off. Kevin Smith again from the goal line. And he brought it to the 30-yard line, tackled by Eric Martin, who had the big hit on kickoff coverage a moment ago. Matt, you and I were in Norman, Oklahoma last year when Florida State played at Oklahoma. It was an absolute dominant performance by Oklahoma at home. Do you expect it to be different this time around?
Yeah, I do. I think E.J. Manuel gives them a dimension that they didn't have a year ago. I think defensively they're a lot further along than they were a year ago. But having said all that, you still have Landry Jones, who's throwing as good as anyone in the country, and Ryan Broyles at the receiving end.
Price back shoulder throw to Kaysen Williams, ruled in bounds with a 12-yard gain, then out of bounds. First down, Andrew Green had the coverage.
back shoulder, just go up and get it, and then get 1 foot in bounds, which he does clearly right there. Good call by the officials.
He is a big-time recruit, Kaysen Williams, true freshman. Out of Sammamish, Washington, his dad was a four-year letter winner for the Huskies, a wide receiver. Polk, the ball carrier. Here's what a good athlete Kaysen Williams was, Matt, in high school. Three times he was the Seattle Times Boys Athlete of the Year, his last 3 years in high school. Won three state titles in football, caught 235 balls in high school. And as a high school senior in track, he swept the state 4A titles in the long jump, the triple jump, and the high jump.
Yikes.
Everybody wanted him. He was the state player of the year in football and in track. After the 2 yard run by Polk, second and eight, the 44. Price throws again. Good catch by James Johnson across midfield and just short of the first down. Andrew Green, another tackle.
You know, you're talking about all, we talk about all these young freshmen and young players and sophomores, and this Washington team is loaded with young players that are very talented. I think Coach Sarkisian's done a great job of recruiting these last few years.
Especially given that he stepped into a program that was 0-12 the last year under Tyrone Willingham, right before he arrived from USC. Polk picks up the first down and an additional two to the 46 of Nebraska.
You heard head coach Bo Pelini talking to Heather at halftime about the same things we were talking about in the first half, about how they're giving him motion and shifts and making that defense have to adjust. And it's a young defense also for Coach Pelini's team. And so when you have young guys, you try to simplify things as much as possible and try to get as many rules out as possible. But all that shift of motion, you have to be right, and you're a half a step out of position, they'll take advantage of it.
Out of the gun, Keith Price, sophomore quarterback, handed it off to Chris Polk. Plenty of running room up the middle, and he has another first down at the 35-yard line. Here's Robert Flores.
Hey, Sean, AT&T All-America Player of the Week update. Clemson beating Auburn today. Taj Boyd, a big reason why. Four touchdowns, 371 yards as Clemson snaps Auburn's 17-game winning streak. Dabo Swinney saying afterwards, it's only fitting that an Alabama grad would do it. Text 55862 to vote and for a chance at a trip to the national championship. Sean.
Well, Dabo was very fired up in that post-game interview on our air. Keith Price after the fake. Rolls and sets and contact in the secondary. Will Compton, the linebacker, running in coverage with the tight end Austin Safarian Jenkins. Ball was underthrown. It's incomplete.
Well, this guy has been absent from the offense the whole second half, and this is a sure big play, but Price could not get the ball to him. He underthrew it completely. He had him beat. He was on top of Compton. Couldn't get it there.
Compton got his hands on Safarian Jenkins. He's had one catch today. Lateral to Curse. Breaks tackles. Gets shoved out of bounds by Levante David, but it's a first down for Washington. Trying to climb back into this game. Looked like they lost their poise for a little while with the developments.
Really like how they're coming right back into it. They're going back to what they did earlier. And that's the short passing game. They'll take a shot every now and then, augment it with the run inside. But they're putting everything back on Price's shoulders, and he's responding.
4 minutes to go, third quarter, a 15-yard game. Got Washington to the 20. Price zings one, and incomplete. Farian Jenkins got a hand on it. Levante David had the coverage that time.
I said earlier at the end of the second quarter that they needed to get Safarian Jenkins more involved. He's a big man. He's just a young guy. I mean, he's 18 years old. He's 6'6". He's 260 pounds. He is a guy who's a mismatch inside this red zone. And he runs well, Sean. So you put a linebacker on him like you saw in Compton, he'll go right past him. This kid's got a huge future.
Bryce trying to get away from Cameron Meredith. And now Crick, he got it off. Battle for the ball.
Tie goes to the runner.
Ciante Evans and Devin Aguilar. And they're ruling it a catch for just the reason you said.
Good job by the official. And a risk taken there by Price. Just kind of giving one of those Brett Favre, here you go.
And Price got up limping. We mentioned he's been having knee trouble coming in.
Cameron Meredith gives chase, and then Crick gives chase.
What a play by Aguilar.
Yes,
stopped
right.
The ball with his left hand. And he managed to have enough strength to battle Evans to a tie. And in that instance, it goes to the offense. Here's a huge third and eight with 3 minutes to go in the third quarter. Quick pass caught by Kurz. He does not get the first down.
I would go for it here. You have to, Sean. You're down three scores.
And if you kick a field goal, you're still down three scores.
Exactly. So you got to get back in this game. And that throw right there is completely on Price because he threw it behind him. Had he led him, it was a first down. Nice adjustment, however, on the catch.
Biggest play of the game for Washington to this point. With under 2.5 to go in the third quarter. Fourth and two. From the Nebraska 12. Amosa, the fullback, lined up in front of Polk, the tailback. Price running out of time, taken down. Back of the 14 by Jared Crick and Cameron Meredith.
Great coverage that allowed Meredith to use his motor and finish this play. You have to take care of Seferian Jenkins, okay? Compton's on top of it. Good job. Then you have to take care of the receiver down the field. So the corners on top of that. And that forces the quarterback to redirect to come back. And that's when Meredith finishes it off with a great motor.
Junior from Huntington Beach, California. Brings it into an 11-play drive for Washington that resulted in no points. Aaron Green, another freshman running back in there. He bounces out to the 19. Sean Parker made the tackle. They're looking at that knee of Keith Price again. Snap it with 17 seconds on the play clock. Aaron Green gets the first down. I know we're a minute and a half left in the third quarter, Matt, but if you're in Nebraska, wouldn't you run the play clock down
take
much
all
more
down.
Than that as many times as you can with a three-score lead?
And that's awareness of Martinez, and he'll get that. Here's Nick Montana warming up.
He's the backup quarterback. He might come in if Price can't go with the knee trouble. Tyler Legate, the fullback rumbling. Pulled down by Desmond Trufant.
Tyler Legate reminds me of a former Husker, Corey Schlesinger. Just thick, tough, and you give him the opportunity and he responds.
It reminds you of every other Nebraska fullback that they've ever had. They all look the same. They don't carry the ball much anymore. Legate had a rush last week. And that was the first carry by a Nebraska fullback since 2004.
Yikes.
And it went for 1 yard. That one went for 36 yards.
You'll show them.
Yes. They'll be lighting up the talk shows here. I told you they should give it to the fullback more. Gracie Anunua delivered the stiff arm. Justin Glenn finally made the tackle. It looked like he delivered the stiff arm to Quentin Richardson.
Watch this stiff arm by Anunua. That's the way you do it. That is Walter Payton-esque. You know, when you played against Walter, you knew that that thing was coming, and he used it as a weapon. And when you got close, bam, he gave you a shot right in the face. Anunua. He was a nice impersonation of Walter.
They talk about what a physical blocker he is as well. And his teammates love that effort. Sophomore from Moreno Valley, California, Quincy Inunua. That is the end of the third quarter. Nebraska outscored Washington 17-0 in that quarter. They lead 37-17 as we head to the fourth. Back in Lincoln, Nebraska, heading to the fourth quarter. The Cornhuskers leading Washington 37-17. Nebraska 19-2 under Bo Pelini when they rush for 200 yards or more. They put 383 on the Huskies on the ground in their regular season win. Then Washington stuffed the Nebraska running game in the Holiday Bowl. The 223 on the ground today for Nebraska. And more as Martinez broke the tackle, got the first down, and then slid down at the 22-yard line.
Smart, smart by Martinez. Doesn't have to take more hits. Keeps the clock moving. This offensive line has played well. We have a Washington Husky down on the field.
Princeton Fuimaono, starting outside linebacker from Long Beach, California. You're looking at his leg. Heather, they've also been taking a long look on the Washington sideline at the quarterback, Keith Price.
Indeed they have, Sean. Keith Price is still walking very gingerly on that left knee that he hurt on the last series. The trainers have been testing it. He's been testing it. Now, don't forget, he sprained his right knee in week one. This new injury is his left knee. He turned to his backup quarterback, Nick Montana, said, "I'm fine." Then he turned to the trainer and said, "I'm fine." He even turned to me and said, "I'm fine." Sean, he said it so many times, it's almost like he's trying to believe that he's A-OK.
I guess he's fine. Fuimaono limping off.
Again, and another young player, just a sophomore. You know, speaking of young players and the way this offensive line has played for the Big Red of Nebraska, they got themselves a good looking one, and just a freshman, Tyler Moore, number 73. Boy, he's athletic. He's got toughness. He's got size. He was fun to watch on tape this week. He's going to have he has a real bright future.
Yep.
Just a freshman.
True freshman from Clearwater, Florida. Enrolled in January, so he had a chance to go through spring ball, but he's the first true freshman offensive lineman ever to start a season opener for Nebraska, and he started all three games now for Bo Pelini. First and 10. Nebraska to Washington 23. Leading by 20 and looking to pad the lead. Aaron Green, a nice cut back. Down to the 15. Sean Parker made the tackle. 8-yard gain. And Taylor Martinez has 125 total yards or more. They win every time. They lose every time he doesn't. They're 0-4 when Martinez is held under 125 total yards. Seems hard to believe anybody could hold him under 125 total, but Washington did it in the bowl game. There's Taylor's dad, Casey Martinez. Second and 2. Aaron Green again trying to find some room outside. Down to the 7-yard line. True Fonten Dennison made the tackle. First and goal, Cornhuskers.
This is where the Nebraska offensive line can really use its strength and its bulk and just keep on wearing on a defense. And then Nebraska keeps bringing these young kids in one after the other. And it's just a wave of talent.
Looks like maybe some of the fight is starting to go out of the dogs. Tyler Legate again, driven back by Haoli Jamora. We've been talking about this offensive line. Three players who came as walk-ons, including Seung-Hoon Choi, mentioned in the first half. Came over here as an eighth grader from Seoul, South Korea, never seen football. Wasn't going to play football at Lincoln Christian, but coaches saw a player they described as kind of roly-poly. Had never lifted a weight. They got him in the weight room, introduced him to football. He kept taking his helmet off. Coach said, "Why are you taking the helmet off?" He said, "It hurts." They didn't have a helmet big enough for him. They took most of the padding out of the inside, left enough in just to make sure it was safe. He didn't really speak the language, so he really didn't understand football terms. But after 4 years in high school, he could bench 450 pounds. Was invited to walk on here, and he has become a starter as a junior. Timeout, Nebraska. Second and goal for the Huskers. We come back. Sean McDonough, Matt Millen, Heather Cox back in Lincoln, Nebraska. The Cornhuskers leading by 20, trying to add to their lead. Early in the fourth quarter, second and goal from the six. And Green, touchdown. He got away from Ta'amu behind the line of scrimmage, and it was all over after that. Second touchdown of the day for the freshman from San Antonio.
Aaron Green has got speed. This Nebraska team has speed everywhere. But if it turns into a foot race to a corner, it's not going to happen. They will win it every time. And not only they get to the edge, watch Big Joy. Just gets on him and mauls him. Well done there by Hardrick, number 50, also allows him to get the edge.
Bonner adds the extra point. Big day for Aaron Green. It's turned into a frustrating day for the Washington fans who've made the trip. Two touchdowns today for the freshman Green.
ESPN's College Football on ABC. Brought to you by Buffalo Wild Wings. Wings, beer, sports. And Nissan, proud partner of the Heisman Trophy.
Well, the Griswolds would love it here in Lincoln, Nebraska. We have the world's largest collection of licorice. We've got a tractor museum and also the National Museum of Roller Skating with archival material dating back from the wooden skates of the early 1800s to the fancy aerodynamic present day rollerblades.
I wonder if my buddy Run Run Jones was in there of the Bay Area Bombers.
Their way into the end zone with regularity. The Cornhuskers, three straight games to open the year now against Chattanooga, Fresno State, and Washington with 40 points or more. The last time a Nebraska team did that, 1995, when they had an undefeated national championship season directed by Tommy Frazier. Kevin Smith with the return up the numbers and now toward the middle of the field. Picks up a block across midfield and finally chopped down inside the 33-yard line by the kicker, Brett Maher. 64-yard return by Smith.
It's well blocked, and then Smith just uses his eyes. Once you get past that first level, it's all instinct when you're taking these things back. Good patience right there to allow him to get a pick of a block. Nice return.
Line of scrimmage, the 32. It is still Keith Price at quarterback on the gimpy knees. Chris Polk. Wrapped up by Sean Fisher, outside linebacker, missed all of last year with a broken leg. Here's a look at our Pacific Life game summary. As the nuisance miss continues to fall here, much to the chagrin of Heather Cox, it's 44-17. Good day for Martinez. Burke had a couple of touchdowns that were 9 seconds apart. Keith Price threw two early touchdown passes. They have had a hard time sustaining offense lately. On second and six, zips one, caught, and then lost by Aguilar. He's had a couple of key drops.
That one was big because Aguilar had six right there. There was nobody to the left of that whole field. Watch Aguilar going to come across back inside. Coverage falls, but to the left of your screen, there was no one.
Yep.
He would have just coasted right into the end zone.
Without question, Price was getting ready to celebrate a touchdown. Instead, they regroup. Aguilar's had two catches. He's had two big drops. Third and six. Five receivers, three and a bunch to Price's left. He throws in that direction. That ball's caught by Aguilar for a first down near the 10. Pushed out by Will Compton. Nebraska middle linebacker. His brother Cody wrestles here.
A
What a Nebraska. He's only 157 pounds, though, Cody, where Will's a solid 230-ish.
And that 157 weight class is a brutal weight class.
Will Compton's going to graduate in December. He wants to be a coach. Quick throw to Aguilar. Give him credit. He's bounced back with two receptions after the drop. They're at the one-yard line after we hear from Robert.
All right, Sean, Navy hasn't played an SEC opponent since 2004. They jump on top against South Carolina. John Howell, 27-yard touchdown. South Carolina's 2-0, but they've given up 79 points in the two games. They're down early at home.
And big points put up against them by East Carolina and Georgia in the first two games for the Gamecocks. Second and goal. Bo Pelini wants a timeout. They didn't see him. Now they did. Just before the snap, apparently. He came racing down the sideline inside the 20-yard line, screaming for a timeout. ...10-19 to go. Washington trying to inch closer. Down 44-17. Second and goal from the two. Quickly out of the huddle, right over the ball. And Polk is into the end zone. Touchdown, Washington. First score of the second half for the Huskies. First touchdown of the day for Chris Polk. After 27 unanswered points from Nebraska. Eric Folk adds the extra point. It's 44-24. ...10:15 to go. Of course, Keith Price, first year starter, won the job in spring practice, taking over for the great Jake Locker. And in the spring game, the Huskies used some innovative technology to help assess Keith Price's performance.
All right, let's go. I know y'all tired. Let's get in.
Hey, March 54.
Say go.
Blue white, go. Hey.
It was a helmet camber designed by a couple of University of Washington graduates. Steve Sarkisian said he was looking for a couple things. He wanted to make sure the quarterback's eyes were in the right place. And it's tough to tell from that camera exactly where they are, but you get a general idea.
Sure.
And wanted to know about his leadership in the huddle.
Yeah, his presence in the huddle. And I think that's the big thing when you're with a young quarterback. You want to see what kind of control he takes of the huddle. He passed that thing with flying colors. And then it's a good, you know, a year ago, we were with Rich Rodriguez in Michigan when they did the same thing with Denard Robinson. They wanted to see where he was looking and how it affected his decision making. And I think today what you would see with Keith Price is that he passed that test again with flying colors. I think you got to be pleased. If you're a Washington Husky fan, you got to be pleased with this young quarterback. I think you're going to see a lot of good things out of him. I think things fell apart here today in the second half. But having said all that, they got a lot of good young players, and he is a huge piece to the puzzle.
Let's go. All right.
Well, last year in the two games against Nebraska, woo, what a hit. Braylon Hurd got leveled by Garrett Gilliland, a backup linebacker, after a gain of a couple to the 28. Last year, Washington, in the two games combined, completed a total of 10 passes against Nebraska. There was one completion thrown by Jesse Callier and 9 by Jake Locker. Keith Price, 18 completions in one game against that same defense today.
Yeah, I think he's come out of it. They'll feel good about a lot of things they did. There's some things they're not going to feel good about. The turnovers, there's nothing they can do about. But they wanted to be physical on Martinez, and I don't know why they have him in the game, incidentally, right now.
I don't think it's still a game. Three-score game. Court Dennison runs Braylon Hurd out of bounds.
Taylor Martinez is an asset. He that short to intermediate game of this passing game, he does pretty well. And then he certainly can really run, and he forces you on the edges all the time to really have to run. The counter game is what they'll come back with next, because you got to flow that hard you bring something back the other way, that'll be effective.
This time he does let the play clock run down, in part because he was looking to the sideline for signals. They come after him with a blitz, and he dives into the turf. He didn't like the fact that Fui Maono finished him off. Well, that's a clean play, and it'll be a punt by Nebraska.
Three-score game. If it's a quick score, 8.5, it might turn it into something here, Sean.
Mm-hmm. Washington has all three timeouts left. Fourth punt of the day for Brett Maher. Kason Williams back deep. Fresno State ran a punt back for a touchdown last week against Nebraska. That one's out of bounds. Official still walking up the near sideline, waiting to mark it. They're going to mark it, it appears, near the 47-yard line.
Sean, Washington gets the football back right now with a quick score.
Would and you go no huddle?
Yes, I would. That's one of the things I wanted to bring up. This last series that they had, they took way too much time. They speed the pace up a little bit. They have three timeouts. You get a quick score, get the ball back again. Hey, stranger things have happened.
Price throwing a deep ball. There's a flag down in the secondary. It's incomplete, intended for Jermaine Kearse with Austin Cassidy, the safety, running in coverage. Crick was putting pressure on Price again. The flag thrown at the Nebraska 34-yard line.
Holding. Defense, number 11. 10-yard penalty. First down.
This Nebraska team really needs Alfonso Denard to get back, because this young secondary is really green. You're going to watch it right there. There's the hold.
Might have saved the touchdown with the hold.
Yeah.
Slowed Kearse down enough when he was about to go by Green. Alfonso Denard did not play today. Outstanding cornerback. Missed all three games. Now with a quad injury. Chris Polk tackled by Andrew Green. That was a big tackle. Polk might have been off to the races. It'll be second down and two. They're at the 35.
I think when you look, and the Nebraska coaches look at this defensive play, they'll be doing a lot of coaching in that secondary this week, both on the coverage side and a lot of rules.
Polk again has the first down and more. He's over 100 yards, fighting his way inside the 20. Great effort by Polk down to the 10-yard line. Chase Rome, a backup defensive tackle, made the stop.
And I like their pace.
They're running right up to the ball here.
The whole time.
Midway through the fourth quarter. That's a 26-yard run for Polk. He's run for 100 now in six of their last seven. And a touchdown for James Johnson. Another back shoulder throw by Price. Good catch by Johnson. And Washington has made a game of it, within two scores now with 7:11 to go.
Watch the route. Now, look at the throw is perfect. The receiver, Johnson, what he has to do is he needs to get that defender to his inside, which he accomplishes. And then he also does a good job of forcing the defender in enough to give him some cushion to come back for that back shoulder throw. And Price hit it perfectly.
Just 56 seconds to score the touchdown. On the 9-yard pass, Price to Johnson. Third touchdown pass of the day for Keith Price. We have a ball game again in Lincoln. Two touchdowns by Washington in a span of 2 minutes and 54 seconds. They've cut a 27-point deficit down to 13. Prior to that last touchdown drive.
Yeah, I'm good. Oh, I'm good. Yeah, my other knee, I'll be good.
Keith Price assuring Doug Nussmeier, the offensive coordinator, quarterback coach, that he's good. Here comes an onside kick. He was good on that drive, and the ball is loose. Jermaine Kearse went up in the air and looked like he had a good shot at it. There is a flag down. Looks like Justin Blatchford recovered for Nebraska.
Kick catch interference, kicking team, 15 yards from the spot of the foul, first down.
Well,
you know, I've been watching football for a long time.
You ever see three of those against one team?
Never.
And Steve Sarkisian hasn't liked the call on any of the three of them.
Well, this one I would understand more than the other two, because he has to allow him an opportunity. Can't interfere with him to make the catch. Although he can actually, that's an onside kick. He has an opportunity to go for the ball as well.
Steve Sarkisian really hot on the sideline. Rex Burkhead to the 36-yard line. Steve still hollering at Dave Whitvoet, the official.
Well, he can yell.
So when the ball hits the ground on an on, you squib an onside kick. You have to wait till somebody on the other side of the field has a chance to catch it?
No.
I mean, if they, let's say none of them are up, they retreat from the line, you squib it,
you can
and the ball
it.
Goes 10 yards. What do you have to do? You got to wait till one of them has a chance to catch it?
No.
Well, that ball hit the ground.
There you go again. There you go again, trying to make sense out of something we don't understand.
Rex Burkhead runs out of bounds with a first down at the 27-yard line. Here's Robert Flores.
Hey, Sean, Navy's back on top at South Carolina. Chris Proctor, 5-yard score, caps off a 12-play, 77-yard drive. They're just in the second quarter, and Navy already has 154 yards on the ground.
Wow.
Line of scrimmage. They're trying to kill some time. Burkhead again. Great effort. Ripped down by Justin Glenn, but the crowd loves Rex Burkhead. They always have. You know you're going to get an all-out effort every time. Let's go back to the onside kick. See if I misspoke, Matt, because I thought he kicked it into the ground and then went up in the air, but I think it actually just did go straight up in the air, which would mean that he should have a chance to catch the kickoff in the air. I thought it was one of those he hit the top of the ball down into the ground and it went straight up in the air. So our apologies. A lot of us are wrong today.
Sean, I'll tell you, who hasn't been wrong here in the second half is this offensive line for the Cornhuskers. They've really kind of dominated, actually. They've taken control of the line of scrimmage, and they have just blown people off the ball. Burkhead has been the recipient of their muscle.
And they're running the timeout now on the legs of Burkhead. He's up to 101 yards rushing. He was over 100 in the regular season game between these two in Seattle last year when they had three 100-yard rushers for the fifth time in school history. Martinez was one of those, and he scores. And it'll be 50-plus for Nebraska against Washington for the second time in these three meetings in a year.
I want you to watch what a real fake looks like. Watch his eyes. They're right back inside. And then watch Martinez. He has no idea where that ball is. And once he gets to the top side, you're not going to catch Martinez.
Quentin Richardson got sucked in. Five plays to score, and in all likelihood put the game away. Marg adds the extra point. Martinez Martinez' first rushing touchdown of the day. He's run for 83 yards. Let's take a look at today's good hands play brought to you by Allstate. There's that terrific catch by Kyler Reed earlier in the ball game. He is a terrific athlete.
We have had a bunch of good hands plays they could have chosen from. Kyler Reed gets the nod. But what a game Taylor Martinez has played here today. There's Kyler Reed sitting on the bench. Martinez has played well. Burkett has played well. And all those, you know, all those skill players have been able to have good games because this offensive line really showed up today.
And they leaned on them because here in the second half, Nebraska's run 32 plays from scrimmage, 28 of the 32 rushes, only four passing attempts. And they've run for 203 yards in the second half.
One thing I want to see yet out of the Big Ten, I want to see Taylor Martinez race Denard Robinson.
Similar kickoff to the one Washington just attempted, executed by Nebraska, and the fair catch made by Tim Tucker. Yeah, that would be an interesting race. Denard Robinson was the only quarterback in the country last year who ran for more yardage than Taylor Martinez.
I think Denard Robinson might have the best first step in the country. And that kid in the first step, he is gone. This guy here, he can scoot too.
Nebraska was offside. They're going to do it again. We talked yesterday with Bo Pelini. He said, I like our team's potential. I don't like our team necessarily right now, the way we've played. And there was a column in the local paper today said they not only did they need a win today, but they needed a feel-good win. Mm-hmm. You know, a win that you could walk away from saying they played well, because they struggled last week against Fresno State. Do you think this will be that kind of a win for Nebraska?
No, I think Coach Pelini is going to find plenty of things wrong, particularly in that secondary. That part he'll, and they're going to have to straighten that thing out now. They'll get Dennard back, and that should help. And then he will be happy, however, with his offensive front, and I think with the skill people. That part he will be happy with. His defensive line actually did not play too poorly.
Here's the re-kick by Maher. Caught on the far sideline by Jamal Kearse, the brother of Jermaine Kearse, their fine wide receiver. Well, it'll be interesting to see if Dennard tries to go next week. You get the impression telling the coaches that maybe he won't in their ball game at Wyoming. And the Cowboys are off to an excellent start this year. I think they want to make sure Dennard's ready to go when they begin Big Ten play for the first time with that big ball game at Wisconsin.
That is going to be a great game.
And Ohio State coming here. They'll begin play as a member of the Big Ten Conference for the first time. Price right down the seam. It's caught. And it's a touchdown for James Johnson. Right back come the Washington Huskies on one play. And they're back within two scores with 4.5 to go in all their timeouts.
How good of a throw is this by Price? Watch Johnson. He throws. Oh, that's perfect. Got on top of Lavonte David and just outran everybody to the end zone. That is really well done.
Linebacker running in coverage. Johnson won the battle from him. 52-yard strike to James Johnson. Highly touted coming into Washington a few years ago. Matter of fact, in 09, he was the first Washington true freshman ever to score in his first two games of a season as a wide receiver. But then last year, played in only 7 games due to injury, had one catch. He's had 6 catches for 108 and 2 touchdowns today. So they're still alive, although they have much to do. Heather?
Well, Sean, James Johnson has Nick Montana to thank for that touchdown, because Johnson was actually a little tuned out on the bench without his helmet on, wasn't ready to go out on offense. Nick Montana went running down the sideline about 50 yards to go grab Johnson and throw him out on the field. Lucky for Montana and the rest of the team that Johnson got out on the field for that touchdown.
He is the son of the Hall of Famer, the great Joe Montana. And Doug Nussmeier says Nick has his dad's intangibles. I guess that's an intangible. reminding your teammate you need your helmet and you need to get out on the field.
Always in the game.
There was a terrific quarterback at Oaks Christian High School in Southern California. They're setting up for an onside kick. The backup punter, Will Mahan's going to do it. What are the odds on some sort of kick interference here? Well, that one did go down to the ground first. And Ben Cotton, the starting tight end, fielded it for the Cornhuskers. And there is a flag, and Washington apparently was offside again.
Offside kicking team number 9. 5-yard penalty would be added to the end of the play. First down.
But at least they didn't interfere with the kick. This Thursday, don't miss ABC's new series, Charlie's Angels. Charlie has 3 new angels. And they're taking down the criminals who are above the law. Things are going to heat up in the city of Miami. It's from executive producer Drew Barrymore. ABC's Charlie's Angels, all new, starting this Thursday at 8, 7 Central on ABC. Rex Burkhead again to the Washington 35. Desmond Trufant, Justin Glenn combined on the tackle. It's one of my favorite shows growing up.
Charlie's Angels?
Yeah.
Charlie's been having angels for about the last 35
Farrah
years.
Farrah Fawcett, Cheryl Ladd, Jacqueline Smith.
Oh, yeah. I remember that.
Original, I believe, cast. And a very strong one. Appeared on many posters of we adolescents around the country back in those days. 300 yards rushing now for Nebraska. Burkhead fights for the first down to the 29-yard line.
Somebody's going to have to make a stop here. You got a 2-score game. You're going to have to watch the clock. Nebraska's going to just keep on grinding away. I'd slow it down, which they're doing. They got to get them to a second and long right here, and then they'll have to stop the clock here sooner or later.
You wonder if they're just worn out now on defense from this relentless ground attack here in the second half in particular. Trufant came on a blitz. They had a hard time getting Burkhead down. Should have been no gain, maybe even a loss. Instead, he struggled ahead for 4. And Washington will use its first timeout. Each weekday at 6 Eastern on ESPN2, don't miss ESPN's new show, NFL 32. It's a highly interactive program driven by social media where you, the fan, help decide topics that will be discussed on the program. You can join Susie Colbert and insider Chris Mortensen, a rotating cast of analysts and guests from all over the NFL. Weekdays at 6 Eastern on ESPN2, NFL 32, where everyone has a voice. Don't expect to be here in mid-September and see people bundled up. Maybe they're so hospitable here in Lincoln, they want to give the folks who made the trip from Seattle kind of a taste of their own weather.
That would be a tall order, but you got it right there, Sean. You know, what a great venue here in Lincoln, number one. But the fans, these are some awesome football fans.
There are. And I think the weather in Seattle, every time I've been, the weather's been beautiful. We were there last September. It's been
gorgeous.
Great, but they do have occasionally some cool and rainy days.
Occasionally.
You have the shot of the purple clad fans in the stands, surrounded by the sea of red. The great Keith Jackson did a Washington game here many years ago and said they look like grapes in a punch bowl. Well, that is what it looks like. Just a few purple clad fans in amongst this tremendous sea of red. Burkhead stopped a couple of yards short of the first down. Will they use another timeout? Yes. 3:04 to go. The Huskies down to 1 timeout.
Okay, so right now, if Washington can stop them here from getting a score, they showed that they can score in an awful hurry and they can get the ball back. Sean, this game is not, this is not as far from over.
It'll be interesting to see if they can stop the third down, what Bo Pelini would do.
Exactly.
Because a field goal would make it 16 points.
Which is a 2-score game.
Yes. It's still it's a very tough 2 scores for Washington. They'd have to score onside kick, score again, and get the 2-point conversion both times. But then again, you run the risk of a blocked field goal. You might just lean on your offensive line to get it on fourth down. It could be a moot point if they get it on third down.
This is big right here. Let's see if Martinez holds on to it around the edge again.
Gives it to Burkhead. He's been the workhorse. They're ready for him. Trufant, the first hit. And a host of Huskies driving back. Last timeout called by Sarkisian with 2:56 to go. Jamora, Glenn also in on the play. And now Bo Pelini has the decision. I think he'd be more inclined to go to a field goal now, wouldn't you, Matt, because they lost yardage on the play. And would be fourth and three from this point.
And his field goal kicker has been hitting them dead center.
He's been perfect all year. Hasn't missed one yet. Ta'amu goes out. Now that might change your mind if you're Bo Pelini, because that is a big loss in the middle of that defensive front. Ta'amu was tremendous in the Holiday Bowl win over Nebraska.
Now he's a big man. He's just a junior, Ta'amu, and he will he'll be playing in a stadium near you in the future and on Sundays. It's a good-looking player.
Looks like they're going to go for the first down. Danny Shelton, a true freshman, number 71, is taking the place of Ta'amu.
Watching him on tape, Sean. Now, he's a powerful kid. He really gets up the field, gives a push.
Right over the center. Huge play here. Nebraska could salt it with a conversion. Washington tried to stay alive. Burkhead stopped. After a one-yard gain, they take over on downs. Garrett Gilliland, the backup linebacker, with a nice play. Sophomore from Anaheim, California. Well, they stopped Burkhead for a loss on the previous play, his only negative rushing play today, and then a turnover on downs to the chagrin of the Pelinis.
This team has not quit at all. This is an impressive effort here.
No timeouts, 2:51 to go. They need a touchdown, need to get it back on an onside kick. Price hobbled by those two sore knees. Was in the open field, and you could just see it catch, and he settles for an 8-yard gain, and the clock continues to run. He's going to stay in the game.
Heck, you look like Joe Willie Namath right there.
Now you wonder, can he zip the ball downfield? They need to get big chunks of yardage. What kind of a throwing base does he have? Plenty on that throw, up for grabs and broken up. Josh Mitchell had the coverage on Devin Aguilar. They need to convert first before they go down the field again. Would you expect a running play here? Move the chains,
he always
get the first down?
He always has fourth down. I would think he's going to throw it again here. Mm-hmm.
They do give it to Polk. They'll get the stoppage of the clock to move the chains. He made the 41-yard line before he's driven back by Levante David. First and 10, Washington, 2:12 to go, down by 13 points, no timeouts.
Clock stops with the first down. Nice pace, nice hurry up. They're right back to the line of scrimmage.
Keith Price is thrown for 268 yards and four touchdowns. Throws, caught, but because it was behind Aguilar, he had to slide to catch it. The clock runs.
He'd have been better off if he just let that thing be dropped it or just let it go. Time, they need time.
6-yard gain, second and four. 1:45 and running remaining. Price, very little rush. Picks up a block, throws it up for grabs. It is intercepted. Picked off by Austin Cassidy.
That was a pure mistake by Price. When he reversed field, he just needed to kill it, just stop it. And he tried to make a play. Cassidy read it the whole way. I saw him break on the ball, anticipated it perfectly.
First interception of the year for the Academic All-American, Cassidy. And I guess, Matt, at that juncture, down by two scores, no timeouts, needing 16, or needing, uh, rather, 13. You got to take a chance sooner or later, and Price decided it was worth the chance. Now they'll just take a knee and run out the clock. Three turnovers by Washington in the second half.
Washington's got something here, though, Sean. And you saw what Nebraska had, big offensive line. You know what they have with Taylor Martinez. I think this Washington team came in really not knowing exactly where they were. They're going to come out of here with a lot of questions answered.
7-6 a year ago when they rallied to win their last four games. They were 3-6. Steve Sarkisian went leaning on the running game. They had a terrific late season run, made it to a bowl game for Jake Locker, the other seniors, and won it against Nebraska. And Bo and Carl Pelini won't be happy about the 38 points on the board for Washington. They're accustomed to great defense. Everywhere Bo's been, they haven't played great defense.
No, it's the back part of their defense. That secondary, it needs some help. They're young. They're just going to have to keep on working at it. They certainly have the skills for it.
And they'll get a lot better when they get Alfonso Dennard back at cornerback. So Nebraska goes to 3-0. Washington's 2-1. Third time they meet in a year, and a lot of respect between these two coaches. They both spoke glowingly about each other as tacticians. And it was an interesting chess match to watch. Final score, Nebraska 51, Washington 38. Be sure to tune in to ABC tonight for a dandy at 8 Eastern. Saturday Night Football presented by Southwest Airlines. Number 1, Oklahoma. Number 5, Florida State. Now for Matt Millen, Heather Cox, and our entire crew, led ably by our producer, Bo Garrett, our director, Mike Roy, Sean McDonough saying so long from Lincoln, Nebraska.